In the sky, it's a bird, it's a plane. Flying high, I emerge through the flames. Have no fear, I'm here, so stand back. Melanin activate, the name is Super Black. In the sky, it's a bird, it's a plane. Flying high, I emerge through the flames. Have no fear, I'm here, so stand back. Melanin activate, the name is Super Black. Imagine that, a future that's super black. Long as your skin brown, your superpowers intact. What would your powers be? Just hope it ain't super whack. Spatial manipulation, create a portal that's black. Maybe just super speed, time travel to run it back. Or chi manipulation to keep my spirit intact. As I encounter evils the world face, demons the world makes, I needed the world to stay. Rest in peace to Chadwick, they killed all the Black Panthers. Told us white lies, I still marvel at black answers. Suits in D.C., pray it lead to a civil war. It ain't no Justice League, what's the need to be civil for? Propelled like the juggernaut, it's clear ain't no stopping this. The world in grave danger, who can stop the apocalypse? They killed all the heroes, the new ones don't really care. But if you need me, put your fist up in the air. Yeah, in the sky, it's a bird, it's a plane. Flying high, I emerge through the flames. Have no fear, I'm here, so stand back. Melanin activate, the name is Super Black. In the sky, it's a bird, it's a plane. Flying high, I emerge through the flames. Have no fear, I'm here, so stand back. Melanin activate, the name is Super Black.
Yo, what's happening? It's another Thursday. We are back with the second show of the week. Blerd's Eye View, back again. It's your man up north, the man on the wall, Chris Fury. Thank you for tuning in. Yes, I know what the poster said. It said 8:30. I know. It's been a lot going on, but it's good stuff. Anyway, thank you for tuning in. Thank you for watching us, checking out the Facebook page, Blerd's Eye View Podcast. Also, checking out the YouTube page, Blerd's Eye View, and hit that notification bell and that subscribe button, and you will get a lot more content like we've been giving you so far. Check us out on anywhere you listen to your podcasts, including iHeartRadio, Opulence Radio app, Spotify, Google Podcasts, Apple Podcasts. Let's just put it like this. If you have ears, a car, and the iPhone or an Android, you can find us. We are not hard to find. So thank you. Shout out to our sponsor, Ultimate Wireless and Opulence Radio. Let's get it started. Let's bring the Cinematic Assassin in, because this episode here, just within the past, 2 hours? Yo.
Man.
It's D23 all over again. if you don't know what we're talking about, there has been literally a ton of trailers between last night and today, and they just
keep coming
nonstop. Like, I was in a group chat, and one of the guys was like, he put up another YouTube thing, and I'm like, yo, what is it now? I'm like, what? But it turned out it was some footage from Ant-Man and Quantumania, and it was just kind of more like behind the scenes stuff. And so I was like, oh, okay. I'm like, yo. This stuff I gotta pull up and what's going on, Will?
Craziness, man. Like you said, talking about the trailers, I actually write for another publication, if you will, Pure Fandom. My thing over there, I'm on top of trailer reviews. Trailers drop, I'm right there. Yeah, my quick thoughts. Days like today, give me a second, people. It's coming.
Yes, it's yo, it has been. I'm like, do I put them in order? No, how do I do it? You know, so it's a lot. It's a lot. We're going to be covering a lot of the trailers that we've seen today and yesterday. We're also going to be talking about Guardians of the Galaxy, the holiday special, which it just so happens that's one of the new trailers we have was for Guardians Volume 3. Yeah. So
strike while the iron's hot, man.
Yeah, strike while the iron is hot. And then we'll be talking about Wednesday and cutting into that. And I'm going to put it this way. Jenna Ortega, she's doing her thing.
She did.
She's doing her thing.
Yeah.
I can't get enough of this girl. Side note, she is actually the little girl. I think it's the general little girl. She's the general's daughter in Iron Man 2. Yeah, is it 2? No, 3. Yeah, 3. 3.
Yeah, because the one where he had PTSD.
Yes. But when they were dealing with, I can't remember the character's name, but Pepper had got those abilities for a hot minute. Yeah, it was in that realm. And she actually was the little girl.
Hmm.
She was the daughter. And not a big scene at all. You know, just like, you know, little girl. I think she was like sitting in a wheelchair or something. Like she didn't have a limb or something. It was something like that. So just small role. Miguel Ferrer was the actual general. It was more focused on him.
Right.
You know, so who I can never, even though I see him in a lot of stuff, I'll never forgive him for playing Weather Wizard in that god-awful Justice Society of America film. Made for television. It was made for television.
This exists? This sounds...
Yeah. So I'm going to get into it real quick. All right. So this thing does exist. You can find it at conventions. You may find it on YouTube. I don't know. It's been some years since I've bothered even looking for it. But Martian Manhunter is leading the squad. the actor who's playing him is not the actor you would think. He's actually from MASH. He was one of the doctors from MASH. And so you're seeing him from a certain angle, and it was just like, okay, whatever. He's a good actor. No longer is, I don't think, but okay. This was the roster. Flash, Green Lantern, okay. Hal Jordan, Green Lantern.
Okay.
Fire and Ice. That was the roster. Now.
That was it? I was looking for more names.
It was okay. Roster. It was a small roster.
Okay.
And it's like they almost took a page out from Justice League America of America, where Martian Manhunter was running the show for a pretty, like late 80s, early 90s. You know, he's running the show for a while. The Flash was an out of work actor. His suit looked horrible.
Interesting. All right.
Hal Jordan looked more like Kyle Rayner and Guy Gardner. You know that vest look Guy Gardner used to wear?
Yeah.
It looked like that. And he didn't fly around like you think he would have. He literally took his ring and made a whip to do like a helicopter. And yeah. Oh, Adam, the Adam. That's who else was in that. And okay. Ray Palmer was introduced as a balding, not sniveling, but just kind of a balding buffoon type thing. And he was getting a cat out from underneath the porch. Shrunk down, of course. It was bad. It was
a great affair.
it was really bad. People try not to think about it, but it was. I've seen things. I've seen clips of the Fantastic Four film from 98? I want to say. Yeah, it might have been 98. And Doom looked like Doom, you know, the mask and everything. You've probably seen a meme of it because they wore the classic costumes. But when Reed's hand looks more like the broomstick that you stick inside of a rubber glove.
Oh.
It was during that Dark Horizons time episode, or not Dark Horizon episode, but Dark Horizon Pictures era, where they were always doing Puppet Master movies and all that stuff. It was...
Gotcha.
Roger Corman was the one who directed it. Roger Corman, if you look it up, you're just like, oh, yeah, this is bad. And then you get the one with Jessica Alba. And then after that, you got the one with Michael B. Jordan and Miles Teller. And then that's when you look back at the one from 98, you're just like, oh, we didn't respect you. We didn't give you the love we should have compared to what we ended up getting, you know? So it was, if I find the pictures, I'm going to send them to you. You're going to be like, oh God, I'm so glad I didn't see that. yeah, I've seen some things. I've seen some things where I'm just like, ooh. So for those who are seeing like Marvel films and DC films now, yes, they're not perfect. Not all of them are perfect. I am a Marvel whore. People know that. But at the same time, I still love DC content when it's good. Like, I love Man of Steel. I love the Batman with Matt Reeves, the Batman. It's fantastic. Christopher Nolan's run is actually really good. You know, Michael Keaton's run is good. And then that's where I stop. Val Kilmer's isn't bad. I take it back. Val Kilmer's isn't bad. But yeah, stop after that. Sorry, Clooney. Not sorry. I don't know. It's been one of those errors where you're just like, oh God, I can't believe we've seen this. I mean, people were looking at the Avengers when Hulk punches Thor, and I'm like, that ain't the first time I've seen that. I'm just saying, I seen the TV movie and that Thor was like very Nordic. Like it was it looked like he looked like a Viking. He was dressed. It was an Asgardian Viking. And even the actor that plays him, I see him now. He was like on Disney Channel, Sonny with a Chance. He played the father. He was the father on Sonny with a Chance. And every time I see him, and I'm like, dude, you were Thor. You were Thor. Adventures in Babysitting. Vincent D'Onofrio was the mechanic.
Oh, yeah.
He was the mechanic, and the little girl who was obsessed with Thor looked at him because he had golden locks. He just had a red hat on, and he just happened to be holding a sledgehammer. And the first thing she says is, oh, my, the mighty Thor gets down on one knee and hits the hammer and everything. I was there. I was there. So, yeah, it's been a ride to see a lot of these shows and movies come to fruition. So when people gripe about, I've seen every iteration of Superman, including like syndication runs of the black and white series. Mm-hmm. I've seen the AMC used to show, not AMC, TCM. I think it's Turner Classic. Yeah. It used to be called TCM. It's called AMC now. They used to show like on Sundays. They used to show old black and white Batman serials just to pass the time. Like they would show Three Stooges, and then they would show that. And I'm like, whoa, I didn't know this existed. You know, and then, I didn't know this existed at all. So those were they were something busy. So yeah, to see what I see now, and I'm just like, it's bad. I've seen worse. I've seen Dr. Strange before he was Dr. Strange. I've seen worse. I was in the trenches. That's why I'm just like, yo, y'all here now. They don't know.
Yeah. Listen, I realize I have a mean bias, a recency bias. Like I struggle going back and seeing like old effects and being like, This was what y'all had working with. Okay. So it's like I do not envy the old days, and I will not revisit them. I am spoiled.
I mean, it's just like I can watch original untouched cuts of Star Wars, of the original trilogy. I can watch those. Those remastered ones when they slid in the CGI, and I'm like, yeah, dog, that wasn't it. I was like, that wasn't it, you know. And I don't slight, and I love Star Wars. I don't slight. I'm not part of that group of toxic Star Wars fans. They're out there. I'm not part of that group where I'm like, I hate it. I hate Hayden Christensen. I'm like, no, I've never hated it. I'm like, it just doesn't. It's just the aesthetic doesn't hold up well. The CGI doesn't hold up. If you look at it now, like you're just like, wow, it really doesn't hold up. Story wise, it's fine.
Oh yeah.
Acting wise, it's fine. It's just this the look just didn't really hold.
I'm shoot George Lucas some bail real quick. As a fellow perfectionist, mm-hmm. that was sort of a living display of my worst fear. Like me not really realizing when enough is enough and having the ability to continue tinkering.
Yeah.
George, that just like we talked about Kanye earlier, somebody just need to grab him, be like, sit down.
That's not it. That ain't when I hear, when I used to hear remaster, I used to hear like, oh, they're just making the picture clearer, you know?
Yeah.
Kind of doing like, not really adding much. They might take a deleted scene that they had, you know, sitting in the can and added into the scene, you know, something like that, which they did. But then they turned around like the scene with Han and Jabba. And I'm like, okay, that would have been cool. But you went from puppet Jabba to CGI Jabba, and you clearly can see it. So it was like, that's why a lot of people cheered on when, the last two sets of trilogies popped up, and they were using puppets. You know, they went back. I'm like, yeah, you went back to basics. Well, you can't go wrong. I'm like, you guys are known for your puppet work. Jim Henson's workshop is known, like, who's going to turn down a puppet? y'all run the game right now when it comes to that. So I just see stuff like that, and I'm like, oh my god, no. I'm like, not all CGI is good CGI.
That's fine.
That's just why it works. You know, sometimes practical effects is the best. So
yeah, I know people are scared about Doctor Who with that, because I think Doctor Who is over with Disney now.
Yeah. Well, see, this is the same groups that were scared that when Disney bought Marvel, they were scared. They were like, oh god, they're gonna make Star Wars kids like, they're gonna make Marvel kids like. I'm like, chill out. I'm like, this is the same group that got, when they found out, wait, they bought Fox. What happens to Deadpool? When they found out they got to keep Deadpool, and they're like, oh, it's not gonna be rated R. Chill out. That's a cash cow. They're not stupid.
Yeah, I was like, Disney still likes money.
Yeah. And what did they do? We'll make it where it's parental controls. That's not enough. I'm like, well, I'm sorry. Your kids are geniuses. What do you want us to do? Like, they can get into your phone, Mom. You don't know how to use Amazon. I'm sorry. This is, what do you want them to do?
Yeah.
Like, good Lord. Oh man, before we get into it, we got a little bit of news. So he's going to be kind of a topic tonight, because he keeps popping up. He's the man right now. And I'm talking about James Gunn.
Okay.
As you know, he's taking over the run for DC Films, and he put out a tweet yesterday. And it showed Kingdom Come done by Alex. He showed a cover of Kingdom Come done by Alex Ross. Mm-hmm. And he says, we have some plans in the making. We have some things working out. At which point I'm just like, dude, you can't say stuff like that and then walk away. Like, I'm like, yo, what do you have planned involving? Like, I'm like, are you, what version? I don't know. We know Henry Cavill's back. We know that.
Yeah.
So I know they're not doing the time skip type thing, you know, because Kingdom Come is kind of a time skip. But you obviously have something in the works dealing with Justice League stuff.
Yeah, I think, I think James is going to take his time. I think that was a tease of the idea that there is a bigger picture. That not like Kingdom Come is coming soon, but like, I don't know if that was sort of like his Thanos tease, like there is something big on the horizon.
Yeah.
And I think that was just a little teaser for those that are in the know to get excited.
I mean, when he says making plans, and when you look at the picture again, let me pull it back up. When you look at the picture again, that's literally Superman standing at a table making
pissed off Superman.
Yeah, he's pissed off, but they're making plans. There's like, there's a team of heroes around him, you know, and they're obviously, it looks like Oa, because that's the Green Lantern symbol on that table. So it looks like they're planning something. So maybe that's what he means in that term, just not the characters that you see per se, but just in general, just saying, yeah, making plans.
And I think it might be the same, or not the same per se, but how we got a Justice League, we got a version of the Justice League, and then we got, you know, the original sort of Zack Snyder's vision of the Justice League.
Right.
And remember, in the animated, it went from Justice League to Justice League Unlimited. I think maybe that's where they're driving, is we have a team, but we're about to pull the lens back. You're about to see an even wider universe.
Yeah. Yeah. It is, Will. Ooh. That is, that's the king. It's the cover from Kingdom Come, but hi. I don't think it is Kingdom Come. Kira's in the building, everybody.
Good evening, ladies, gents, blurds.
We're just starting, so nothing.
Okay. Nothing major. Still a thousand pardons.
But yeah, I think James Gunn has a way of using obscure characters and making them work. Yes. And the Suicide Squad is a fine example of that. When I first heard about it, and I'm like, okay, let's take a tally. Who's dying? You know? who's gonna die when they say Nathan Fillion's in it? I'm like, oh, they're not gonna kill Nathan Fillion. They're not gonna kill Boomerang. Well, I lost all my money. So, you know, stuff that happened in that film, and you're just like, okay, that's cool. But here it is, you had a whole new set of characters, and it wasn't built so much around Harley. It just had Harley in it. Everything else was like, it was really Bloodsport and Peacemaker and Ratcatcher 2 and Polka Dot Man. I never thought you would use Polka Dot Man, and then I look back and I'm like, okay, it's not bad.
Everybody talks about him. Everybody always craps on him.
Yeah,
but I mean, he's got a you know, a particular power that's dangerous. You might want to, you know, judge it up a little bit as you will.
Yeah, you put King Shark in, and you make him basically one-liners all day. You know, and
voiced by Sylvester Stallone.
I'm like. You know, you have Starro as the main catalyst is why they're doing this, and you're just like, somehow this shouldn't work, but yet
here it is.
Did. And then he still gave you a crazy extra credit scene with the weasel.
Oh, God.
And it worked. It absolutely worked. And then it leads into Peacemaker, and you're like, dude, you are doing something.
He was building. He was building a world as soon as he got hired. As soon as he got, like, how do you come up with that stuff? After he got fired from Disney, I'm very certain that he was thinking up new pitches for Warner Brothers immediately. Like, what? Anyway, did we talk about that? I don't know if we missed.
No.
They fucked up. They fucked up.
Yeah.
So bad.
I've never seen, I'm like, dude, you got fired over some old stuff. And then you turn around and got rehired. That's cool.
The Birdman, I can't.
Oh, yeah. DC was doing the Birdman when MCU fired him the first time. Yeah. And it's just funny to me that I'm like, yo, I've seen James Gunn films before. I just never seen him in the aspect that he has him in until he started doing like Guardians, which
I remember picking up Slither. I remember watching Slither and watching it all the way through without really going, this is the dumb. It's the dumbest.
It's so goofy.
It is the dumbest.
But because because I love Nathan Fillion, I'm like, but because Nathan Fillion's in it and Michael Rooker, and I'm like,
it's good.
Goofy and it's good at the same time.
Yeah.
You know, and I was sold when the woman was in the barn. She was like, I don't feel so good. I'm like, you're about as big as the barn right now, lady.
Oh my God. Oh my God, that was horrible.
And some of the lines that were said, and I'm just like, this is just gold right here. You know, he has a way of putting that comedy into it.
I want to say he does better B movies than it's gonna bug the hell out of me. Living Dead. Oh my God, it's gonna bug. Hold on. It's got Bruce Campbell in it. Army of Darkness. He does better movies than that.
Yeah.
In my opinion.
And you know, Sam Raimi. Yeah. Sam Raimi does. Look, let's put it just like, wherever Sam Raimi is, Bruce Campbell has a job.
100%.
Yeah. Wherever James Gunn is, his brother Sean has a job. I mean, like, that's what it is.
That's what I pray over my life, is that I can either be that person for someone or be that someone's person.
Yes.
Like,
I see them get a job. I know I got a check coming. Just right. like
Adam Sandler. Look at Adam Sandler.
Oh my God.
That whole crew from Saturday Night Live from that era, all he got to do is, I'm making a movie. Oh, he'll call me up. I'm not worried. He was like, I'm not worried. Yeah, you have a job. Yeah, when you're go for direct, not Danny Elfman, but who did win?
Wednesday, you're talking about?
Yeah,
Tim Burton,
Helen Bonham Carter, Johnny Depp.
Oh yeah,
didn't always have a job.
Yeah.
Tend to always have a job, you know. So it's just kind of a when you got a niche,
stick with it. You know it's gonna work.
Yeah, like you know, when you got a niche, hey, here it is. So I don't, you know, but yeah, James Gunn, I have complete faith in what he's doing with the entire DC property. You know, like I said, he has a way. He's just like, okay, that's great. We have Batman and Superman and Wonder Woman. That's great. Let's concentrate on some of these other heroes. Let's start bringing them into the fold and seeing how that works. And I'm for it. I'm all for it. You know, look how well he did with Guardians.
Those are like C-list characters, to be honest.
They really are. They're C-list characters who are now up on the roster because of him. Because nobody was looking for, I knew of the Guardians, but I didn't buy one Guardian book. Not one. I still don't, but...
Because it's not the same as the movies.
Right. You know, I knew Peter Quill. I knew Groot. You know, I knew Yondu. I knew Rocket. I knew Gamora and Nebula. I knew all of these people, but I wasn't buying those books.
No.
You know, I'm a mutant. I'm in the X-Men. I'm in the Spider-Man. I'm in the Fantastic Four. I'm in the Black Panther. So I wasn't buying those books. But here he takes pretty much a rotating cast, really, because in the comics, that's a rotating cast, except for now, because he's made them so popular. Like Peter Quill's just constantly on the team. Groot, constantly on the team. Drax, constantly on the team. Like these people are always on the team. So he's just put them in the forefront now. Instead of being like, okay, you guys were C-listers. Now you're kind of up here. You're like, you know, you're higher up on the echelon at this point.
People want to see them on a regular basis now.
Hey, Clover, how you doing, sweetie?
Hi, Clover. Yeah.
She's an amazing mermaid.
Oh.
She does amazing.
Them fishtails are expensive, man. Props to you, man. I just learned about those things a couple of days ago. Girl, your credit score is perfect.
So, speaking of which, before we go further, this AI thing has my people in a complete chokehold.
Yo, the whole timeline.
Yeah. It is so fucking good.
I was like, all right, everybody else's looks really nice. Blah, 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 blah. Let me just put the... Oh.
Oh. Got the cosplay juices running again. I'm like
that. I got my Faye Day costume picked. It's done. It's done.
I'm looking at Black Faye Day for the Royals event they got going next year. I'm like, oh,
say less.
I said, let me redo my Chris Fury persona, and I'm like, oh my god, how did y'all upgrade the gun? How?
Yeah, oh my god. The stuff that they put in the Dormilaje costume. Now I look like a mix between her and the Tomb Raider. I welcome this. I thank you.
There's artificial intelligence.
And,
oh my god, there's a pic on there. I swear I look like I'm on the cover of an R&B cover, and I'm like, I need to do that.
Yes. Yes.
I'm like, I got the jacket and the hat. And I'm like, I can cosplay without worried about my glasses now. Thank you. I don't have to lose the glasses.
Will, when you do it, Will.
You might as well.
When you do it, Will. Will, just throw up a couple. You ain't got to do a lot. They just need five pictures. You good.
Yeah, you go in there and you can pick 10 because I ended up picking 10 and then I'm like, get the 100.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is only $2. I'm like, get the 100.
Yeah.
And I was just like, oh.
Yes. I didn't know I looked this good. Thank you.
A friend of mine, Shaq, out there, shout out to Shaq Harper. He was like, man, I spent like $40. I'm like, dude, get out now.
$40?
It was like he just kept going in, getting more. I'm like, get out now.
Whoa.
Oh, man.
No. Will, you. Sorry.
Oh, no, that's even. Will, go in there. You even with your locks, trust me. When you go in there and look, mm-hmm. you be like, yo, you're going to be walking. You know how they got those skits where it say when brothers go to the barbershop and they get a lineup and they come out feeling like a brand new man. When you see these pictures, you're going to be looking at your wife like, hold on. Wait, I am too fine for you talking to me like that.
Nah, Will, I saw somebody with locks. You're going to be fine.
Oh, yeah.
You're going to be fine.
There was one that had me literally, I'm like, I need to hit the gym again.
And somebody
was like, yeah, you look like Blue Marvel. I said, you better stop.
Ew, that the fairy with the snatched waist.
Oh,
ooh, I'm gonna be a problem in the summer.
I was like, we all gonna be at Planet Fitness or somebody's Bally's or something. Like
everywhere. Any
the AI app, they were like, yeah, okay. They showed me what I can be.
Mm-hmm. I believe
I can do it. But yeah, it's dope. I'm like, when I say it has people, it has our people in a chokehold.
The cripple hand.
Ugh. Shout out to Candy B because she kept saying it was like this thing is choking me. She's like, I'm done for real, for real. I'm like, no, you're not. Like she had one that gave. She literally had one, and it looked like Storm. She looked like Storm. Another one. She was like, I'm feeling this Android thing, and I said, it's looking like Janelle Monae. She was like, exactly. It's dope.
I got a couple of different pictures I need to put up, but
I my phone's full of them now. I was just like. Have at the peasants,
please. Blessings.
Got me feeling in my got me in myself. What the heck? Oh man, yeah. He said, oh yeah, I've seen our community. Yeah, they passing them out. It's like Candy Crush, right? It is. Lynn's another one. Lynn just put hers up today. Yes. Okay.
Yeah. That's why, see, Lynn, I'm with you because there's a couple that
Lynn's not alone. Kira, I seen yours.
Yeah.
And it's like two other women that I know. And I'm like, okay, I know they do, but how does the I know that's not the camera shot they gave them.
Like, absolutely not. Absolutely
like,
not.
Because every sister I see that put their picture up said the same thing. It was like, I don't know how it knows I have big boobs. But I do, and yet,
we need the face, not just Roxy, relax.
That's who it was, Roxy Hayes. She was like,
"Oh, girl, I saw her."
The AI,
ma'am.
She was. They said, "Roxy, you gave him a spicy pic." She was like, "No,
no, it knew. It just knew."
I'm just like, okay.
AI said, "More boo."
We're at full capacity. More.
They require more. But yeah, it is. It's really a dope app. You can get in there, get your little pics, change your profile, do whatever, man. And it really is. There's different styles. It's really dope. It's really, really dope. And it ain't a person. I don't know. Let's use this thing. Kurt from Head Nerds in Charge, somehow he turned into a mayo and a Chipotle version of mayo of himself. I don't even know how that happened.
A Chipotle version?
Yeah, because Kurt's a little darker than me. And yet, he's about your skin. Matter of fact, he's about your skin complexion. Mm-hmm. And somehow, he's like two shades lighter than me. So he looks like a Chicano or something. And I'm like, dude. And then I'm like, why do you look like Whitebeard from One Piece? What is going on?
Sir.
He was just like, I don't know how this happened. I'm like, I don't know either. Like, all your pictures is the same look, so I don't know what happened. What did you do? And so, is there something you're not telling me, Kurt? No. Shout out to the cousins in Philly. Kurt, Head Nerds in Charge. I was on the show with them last night talking about Wednesday. But yeah, it's a great app. You don't have to keep it. You can go in and you can do your free trial. You can get in, get right back out. Ooh. You know.
All right, now I'm sold.
Yeah.
Wait. It's a free trial, but you got to pay the $3 to use the AI portion. But that's it. You just pay it the one time.
Yeah. It's not like it.
But that's it. You got it for 7 days. If you want to make like 700 pictures, you got 7 days. to get them 700 pictures into your camera. I don't recommend it.
I didn't give them 24 hours.
I no.
I was just like, you get an hour, and I'm getting mine, and I'm back. Yep. I'm literally like that Homer meme where he was just like, he stepped through the bushes, and backs back. You know how his dad walked into the bar, hung his hat up, walked back around, grabbed his hat, walked back around. So, yeah, it's a cool app, and if you want to check it out, it's for our melanated people. I don't know what's been going on, and it started with She-Hulk because that She-Hulk filter. I was just I look good green.
Oh,
I see why Jennifer's the way she is.
Walking around strutting.
And then I look good red. I'm like, wait a minute.
Wait, there's a red one?
Yeah, there's a red filter.
All right, I'll do that next. Blue is kind of talking to me too. I've seen the blue one.
Look, I just put it like this. Our melanated brothers and sisters, we just look good.
Yeah. Like you can't do wrong.
Yeah, it's doing something. And I've seen the side by side, and I'm like, yeah. Okay.
Can I say something about that app? I mean that filter real quick. I don't know, just something just was resting on my heart as y'all brought it back up. And it's the idea that in the films, the X-Men films, they keep trying to convince me that Mystique is ugly. And it's like every time
you're like, where?
Yeah, it's like when this filter came out specifically, and you see all the beautiful people everywhere in green. I was like, would this movie, are the people that formerly at Fox looking and realizing there's no actual tint of person that you would not be willing to lay down with? Right. Mystique, blue and scaly, was still getting it. I don't understand.
Right. What? I'm like, it was Rebecca Romijn and then Jennifer
Lawrence.
Yes.
Lawrence, yes. And I'm just like, ugly, weird. What's the
problem? Magneto says, show me your real self. And she changed. He said, your real self. I was like, I felt that. I felt what he was saying right here.
Magneto was right. Magneto was right. Charles was trying to get you to fit in, but Magneto was right.
Go natural, baby. You never look back.
That's it. And as Candy B once said, and this is really notice is due to X-Men Apocalypse. She's like, Rebecca Romijn did not slide backwards on her coochie for Jennifer to go ahead and just get painted up.
That is a statement.
It's a statement, and it is true.
It is also true. Jesus
Christ. He said, girl, show me the blue cheeks and then smile.
Wow. Wow.
Take with you, take what that with you, what you will.
And that too.
Exactly. That's for Blerd's Eye View After Dark. Oh man, but so we're getting right into the show. There's been a crap ton of trailers. Before we get to our reviews of Guardians Holiday Special and Wednesday, there's been a crap ton of trailers. They would come so fast, we didn't know when they were going to stop.
No. It felt like it started at midnight last night.
Yeah, they showed absolutely no mercy. Like, so the first one we're going to check out is Mario Brothers. This is Chris Pratt voicing Mario. Sounds like it's a lot better.
There we go.
Yeah, you know, so they seem to be doing their job, their due diligence, I guess. I'm still gonna wait. So we're gonna see this real quick and see how this turns out.
Yeah, I'll be quiet.
Let's go.
Oh my God. OK, okay.
Not sure if you know who I am, but I'm about to rule the world.
Wow, yay.
But there's one problem. There's a human, has a mustache, just like you.
Do you think I know every human being with a mustache wearing an identical outfit with a hat with the letter of his first name on it? Because I don't.
Bowser is coming. Together, we are going to stop that monster.
How? Look at us. We're adorable.
Oh, I got this. No problem.
Yes! Come on, Mario! Our big adventure begins now!
Get it off, get it off, get it off!
There's a huge universe out there.
Whoa.
With a lot of galaxies. They're all counting on us.
Mario!
No pressure.
Okay. Okay. I'm sold. I'm not mad at that.
Will, shush.
I'm not mad at that.
Will, shush.
I'm actually kind of. It's Illumination. Illumination is known for like their minions in Despicable Me films. I'm kind of not mad at that. I'm willing to go check that out. Right, I like Princess. I like Princess Peach with a battle axe. There it is.
No, shut up. Go. Shut up and say what you're gonna say.
Say it.
What? Listen. The poster always looked amazing. The animation looks clean. It's doing a lot of deep cuts for just Nintendo lore with Donkey Kong and Cranky Kong, and it looked like there was a Smash Brothers scene, maybe, and then we get Rainbow Road. Like it's literally hitting every single note you could want it to hit.
Here's the butt.
What's Chris that one?
Man, yeah. I really want to believe it's going to be good, but it's like if you watch this trailer again, they give Peach a lot of lines, like straight dialogue. They give Luigi that little chunk where he goes straight dialogue. Mario, not so much. They give you a little dash here and a little dab here, because I feel like they off the teaser and everybody like reaction to it, they were like, ooh, let's all right, how are we gonna recut this trailer? Let's cut all his lines out real quick and just let's try again.
We got time. We got time. We got till April.
Hey, listen, Chris Martinet apparently is still there. Just whenever y'all want to tag him in.
That one I still don't understand, because if I'm not mistaken, he's actually doing voices in a movie.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So I'm kind of confused. Like, I don't know if it's just weird to me. That part is weird to me. And I don't know if it's because, like, we're paying him a lot now because he's doing all the voices. I'm like, well, just pay him one big chunk and have it be done. I don't know if that's the thing or if he felt comfortable, you know, saying, hey, let somebody else have the shine. People know who I am. Let somebody else have a go at it. You know, it's kind of like the Kevin Conroy situation. Like, we know Kevin Conroy is Batman, flat out. When you get another voice actor doing Batman, you're kind of like, I don't know. Chris. Let's find out.
Chris. I just feel like you work in retail and your manager quit, and so regional director come to you like, hey, we need you to step up for a little bit. And you step up and you doing the damn thing, and you think you might be in there, and then they hire somebody, and now you got to train that person to do their job, the job you've been doing, but they're not going to pay you to do.
That's what I'm saying. I don't know. I'm looking at scenarios. Yeah, I'm looking at scenarios.
Okay, first of all,
not excuses, scenarios.
I'm gonna need y'all to climb way the fuck down from this trailer. Chris specifically.
Why?
I'm calling you out on this trailer. This movie, okay. Let me go line by line. Let me go in my head. Okay. I like the trailer. I love the trailer. I love the notes that it hits. I love seeing Raccoon Mario. That shit touched my heart. I like the little fire flower. Also touched my heart. Chris Pratt got buried. Like you said, Will. He got buried.
Oh, you mean like not getting a lot of shine yet?
Nah. Because they know they fucked up. Now, if you know you messed up, and you did it, so you tried to correct it by taking this man's almost entire voice, except for that key, woohoo, which anybody can do. You might want to rethink about... You might want to rethink putting this man in the movie. Chris, to your point about the guy, Chris Martinet, who don't need money?
Oh, I didn't say he didn't need money.
Who don't need money? And Chris Pratt, he's hurting for a check?
No, because he's got like four movies on Amazon Prime right now.
So explain it to me.
Now, Martinet, I didn't say Martinet was hurting for cash. I didn't even say Chris Pratt was hurting for cash. I mean the studio. Let me put it to you this way. Like right now, we have one of Disney and Marvel's most anticipated films on his way to $1 billion, right?
Mm-hmm.
3 weeks later, they drop an animated feature that is not doing well and is losing $100 million. Why is that? They didn't put enough push behind it.
Because they didn't believe in it. Yeah. But that doesn't have anything to do. Wait.
No, that's money. That's money. Or better yet, we'll use Warner Brothers. They definitely were hurting on cash. It may not look like it to you and me, but they were hurting on cash. That's why we didn't get it. Yeah. They are hurting for cash.
No, they broke.
Yeah. That's why they didn't have, you didn't see pushing like at San Diego Comic Con. Like you didn't see.
They can't afford it.
Yeah. That was,
also, they don't have any real content.
Like what they had, they put it, it's like they dumped it all in one basket in one area and then it got foobarred and thrown all over the wall. So yeah, they definitely are hurting for cash. So that's actually a better explanation. Like they're hurting for cash. Like, so, you know, they can't afford to just like put like a trailer out every 5 seconds.
But
because it costs some money.
Because their movies don't perform as well. Even with them promoting it, their movies don't perform as well as they wanted to. That's the other reason why they're in the hole. But that doesn't explain. I don't know who's the studio behind this movie?
Illumination.
All right. So they're new on the scene. That's cool. How did you afford Chris Pratt in the first place?
That was probably where they dumped it. Well, no, I don't doubt that because that's Jack Black. That's probably, you know, I don't know because Jack Black is doing Bowser. I don't know who's doing the rest of the Luigi. I don't know who's doing Luigi. I don't know who's doing Luigi's Princess Peach.
Charlie Day.
Oh, shit.
Oh, that's my boyfriend. I knew
that's why I thought I recognized him. I'm not used to hearing him in cartoons.
Like, the cast is star-studded. It's just...
But why? Like, everybody...
So why did they... So it does stand the question, why didn't you use...
The cheaper, well-known, the person that has been doing it from day goddamn one. Why wouldn't you use him?
Charles Martinet? I wonder how old he is. It doesn't matter, because if you have him...
Was Mario.
Yeah, if you still have him voicing these other characters, I don't know how that works though.
They should have just not had him in the movie at all. Because I'm questioning everything that they did.
Like, why didn't? I mean, and you're not the only one. There's a lot of people that question, like, why didn't they use Charles Martinet? He's still alive. And then when the word came out that, like, yeah, he's doing voices in the movie already, and it's like, so where was the decision made?
He's only 67. He's not old.
Mm-mm.
He's not. I mean,
well,
but he's not old.
It's up to us.
Yeah,
internet. We did it once. We bullied the hell
out of the people. We did it with Sonic. It was one of the few times.
Fuck up out of here.
It's one of the few times I agreed with bullying. It's the one time I agreed with bullying because
cyberbullying
was not going to work.
Cyberbullying worked that one time.
Yeah, Mark Cooper, what's happening, Mark Cooper?
We can do it again.
So we should. I feel like there has been enough fervor that people have, you know, people's voices have been heard. Mm-hmm. I don't understand. And
maybe it hasn't. I don't even think it's been heard. Like the thing with Sonic. Oh, that was heard. Like they damn near tore down Twitter.
Children crying, and yeah. Running away from their TV screens. Yeah, that
right. Like they damn near tore down Twitter for that one. This one, it's not that. I heard it for like the first couple of weeks, like when we got the teaser, but then I didn't hear anything else.
Yeah, I think maybe it's not. I think Chris Pratt as Mario is not as egregious as Ugly Sonic was in those glimpses we got.
That's fair.
That's true.
That's a, what is it? A fever nightmare? Fever dream?
Yeah. I mean, I still find it weird that I see Bradley Cooper doing Rocket's voice. It's just weird. I mean, I don't knock it. I just think it's weird because I never would think Bradley Cooper would do. Even when I see him doing it, I'm like, huh.
That voice should not come out of that face.
It's just weird, you know? And I'm like, I would never expected that. So, you know, even when you're watching it, you know, sometimes when you watch a movie where the voice acting, you can pick up on the actual actor. Like Jensen Ackles has done Batman twice already.
Yeah.
He's doing him a third time for this Legion of Superhero. And I can hear Jensen Ackles.
Yeah.
You know, so who's it? Tyson Daly, who's done Superman for the animated show and everything else. I can hear Tyson Daly. So Bradley Cooper, I don't hear Bradley Cooper.
I agree. I 100% agree with you there. Because every time I watch a movie, I'm like, that's not a lion. They lion. Yeah. That's not him.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Wish that was Wish Sonic. that was a Wish Sonic. Good Lord. So there it was. Yeah. Who knows? We still got till April. Who knows what's going to happen?
They ain't gonna do a goddamn thing. That money is already counted. Oh, wait, that money is already in the bank. People
they're not gonna not deny. People are not gonna like Will said. It's not as egregious as the Wish Sonic. It was like they were just like, I know you're not feeding me that. Like, you're giving me everything else, and then you give me that. You know, I'm like, yeah, that's not gonna fly. Mm. This one. Hold on, what did you say? Yeah. It's about as guaranteed as Flash movie.
Can I be honest? I want to see it.
I do too.
I want to see it,
but not for the reason people think.
Not for the story. I want to
see how this plays out. Exactly. That's what I want to see. I want to see how it plays
exactly.
out.
Exactly.
I'm like, because you've brought this person back in for reshoots. I want to see how this plays out.
Mm-hmm. I feel like it's going to be a completely different movie.
Yeah.
The Flash is my favorite hero. As a former track runner, the person that can just run fast, it was easy, easy link in my childhood. And it's just,
I feel bad for your knees. I'm just thinking about your knees. I'm so sorry.
My only theory is it's one or two things, and it's probably the first one. And I don't know if you guys are familiar with, any kind of Flash. Well, Will, I know you. If you're a fan, you're familiar with it. But they'll probably take a part of one of the Crisis, and it wasn't. Mm-hmm. It wasn't. Was it Barry that ran, or was it Wally? It was Barry. It was Barry.
It's always Barry.
Yeah, it's Barry. Then it's Wally. and he ran so fast that he pretty much just dissipated. He dissipated. He became part of the Speed Force. And I'm wondering, will they go that route and then turn around and say, okay, he's part of the Speed Force, but he's not dead. And he's coming back, but it's not that Barry.
That would be the smartest way to get out of that problem.
Yeah, because that is a major problem for them.
However, what is it? Then you have the problem of Nightmare, because you put him in that future scenario.
Yeah.
So now what are you going to do?
That's the question. Like, I don't know how they're how this balancing act of theirs. I'm sorry, James Gunn. You have got a job on your hands.
Ooh, I was just about to say, Mr. Gunn, if you're listening, if you want to go ahead and call some more reshoots just to tidy up some things at the back end of that film,
there's a couple people.
You know,
We got Will, we got Nick from Do You Speak Geek. You know, they they got a handle. They're putting it's out there. You might wanna. So this other one, this other trailer, is actually based on a true story.
Oh God. Oh God.
In Tennessee, of all places,
hell of a drug.
Yeah, I want to see this for the simple fact it's such an insane storyline. And I'm looking, as I seen that first trailer, I'm like, yeah, I know all of that didn't happen. I know all of that didn't happen. Like, and it didn't. A lot of that didn't happen. But, you know, for the sake of making a buck, he said, white Bob Miller bring in Gustin or a High School Musical guy. Well, Gustin is the High School Musical. Oh, no, I know what he's talking about. No. And he said, and call him Effective Flashpoint. Yeah, that's the
No. DC can't have High School Musical guy. I'm calling dibs on High School Musical guy. Mm-mm, not with them abs. No, he could come right over to DC. Ah, no, he could come right over to Marvel. Mind your business, sir. Stay in your lane. Don't be trying to
he said, why does it? He said, why does he have to? Well, it happened in Tennessee. So people probably wonder what I'm talking about. The crew know what I'm talking about. I'm talking about Cocaine Bear. Yes.
That's an amazing poster.
Heard that correctly.
I'm glad you put that poster right over my face so you can't see me roll my eyes.
I can't believe this thing exists. I can't believe this happened. I'ma just play it and watch the hilarity ensue because you're talking to somebody who's watched all of Sharknado. So, you know, there's that. Yes, I suffered through those.
Yes,
but here's the thing. I knew what those were going to be, so I wasn't disappointed.
I think everybody knows what they're... But okay. That,
when you know what it's going to be, it doesn't hurt. When you're lied to, like, you know, Suicide Squad, and you're thinking it's Joker throughout the whole film, and it turns out it's not, yeah. It's not like that. I can't believe I'm saying this. Here's Cocaine Bear.
Medic!
Oh Jesus!
It's the IKEA man.
What is that?
Beth, we should go.
Millions of dollars worth of cocaine fell from the sky this morning in Knoxville, Tennessee.
There's more of this out there.
They dumped it somewhere.
I'm looking for my daughter.
Forest is a dangerous place.
Hey, Henry, check it out. Something got into it. A deer, maybe.
A lot of cocaine was lost. I need you to go and get it.
No, don't eat that. Don't eat that.
Let's see what kind of effect that has on it.
The bear, it fucking did cocaine. A bear did cocaine.
There was a bear.
A bear?
It was far.
Hey, that's inappropriate.
You're safe. Bears can't climb trees.
Of course they can.
Oh, shit. It kind of seems like the thing that stays with the man forever.
Apex predator. High on cocaine. Out of his mind.
Oh!
Oh, man, you fucked.
What the fuck is wrong with that bear? Shoot it, Beth! Beth, speed up!
You're higher, baby, and don't ever come down!
We have such good luck in nature.
Lord, don't Jesus. Ask. There are children starving in third world countries. But that got made with millions of dollars. Millions.
Oh, dude, rest in peace, Ray Liotta. It's probably one of his last films.
Oh my God, no.
O'Shea Jackson Jr. is just taking a check. I don't know what my man just taking a check.
It's good. I swear to God. Oh, I swear to God.
He said Sharknado was so bad that you had to watch it, like Final Destination movies. That right there.
It's that. They don't get that man to go, shit. That's what I was wasted opportunity.
All right. Oh, you know what? He probably will. Who knows? Like, if he does, I'm just like, okay, all right. Just give me some more popcorn, please.
Listen, 3 seconds in, and we get the guy from the IKEA TikToks. So it's
you're like, right. So it's like,
I know what time it is. I know what time it is. They know what kind of movie they were trying to make.
Right. He said, who had that on their bigger car for 20? Yeah. I sure as hell didn't.
None of the people got it that got eaten by the bear. That's for damn sure.
He did a line off a dead guy's arm. Like, what the hell?
How do you even set that up? Like,
there are some movies you're just like, you're just making. And so apparently in the actual story, none of that happened. Yes, no. The bear did, like, he did a crap ton of it. And he actually died from a heart attack. Like, you know.
Anybody?
And I was going to say, as anyone would. So to see that, I'm just like, okay. So the rest of this is just like a whole fever dream. Like, this didn't last for like days or whatever the case may be. This was just like, this happened and it kicked in just that fast. You know what would make a great story? Because they wouldn't believe it. You're right. The not real story nobody believes. And so it was just like, yeah, I'll go with it. I'll go with it. So
a great lesson in those phrase. Based on true events. Just
the fact they keep playing white lines throughout the whole movie, the whole trailer. I'm just like, Grandmaster Flash is somewhere. Just like, I'm getting paid, whatever. he's like, I'm getting paid. It doesn't matter. I'll take the money. We have, like I said, they've been hitting us with trailers all day. This one is. And I wasn't sure how I felt about this one. I really wasn't, because Michael Bay. Those last couple Transformer films left kind of a bad taste in my mouth. It just did. I'm just like, okay, this is going way beyond what it needs to be. Your third act has gone and stretched over into a whole nother act. But it looks like they're trying to reset. And I know they tried doing that with Bumblebee, which he wasn't a part of. So it's more of a reset, you know, like a soft reboot, as they like to call it. Like, this is a soft reboot, no continuation, just a soft. We know who they are. We don't need to, you know, understand. But this one is Transformers: Rise of the Beasts. So we're going to get Optimus Primal.
Yes.
I think Cheetah was in this one, and just the beginning. I'm not sure. I'm still waiting to see. I think it's Jazz again. If it's a soft reboot, we got Jazz back. I'm for that.
I very much want Jazz.
Yeah, I was mad that he got taken out the way he did. I'm like, yo, you had the one black Transformer, and you took him out.
That was so disrespectful.
Yeah.
You took the words out of my mouth.
So here's Transformers: Rise of the Beast. Yeah, it was all a dream.
I'm not the one to fear, Prime. There is a darkness coming.
was all a dream.
Pull over!
I'm not driving!
And if you don't know, now you know.
Mirage. It's Mirage.
Spread love is the Brooklyn way. And if you don't know, now you know. I'm blowing up like you thought I would. Call the clip, same number, same hood. It's all good.
Of all the threats from both your past and future,
it was all a dream.
You've never faced anything like this. Let them come.
And if you don't know, now you know.
Let's get it real. Let's get it real. Oh, he's real. Okay. Yeah. That's Mirage. That was Mirage. Not Jazz, Mirage. We got freaking RC in the building. Damn.
Listen, I'm back in.
I'm like, yo, you got RC in here, and I think she was in, not the last one, I think she was mentioned or seen before, but like they those last, not Bumblebee, because Angela Bassett was one of the voices in Bumblebee. She was one of the Decepticons, but yeah, like that one, the last one before that, like it was. And they had Anthony Hopkins in it. I'm like, yo, like this movie was all over the place.
Yeah.
You know, to the point where the Decepticons didn't even transform. They had like nanobots at that point.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm like, now you're just cheating. You know, it's like, not even a fair battle.
No. I don't know why they strayed that. I'm still nervous about this movie. I'm still nervous about this movie because I feel like the rope-a-dope is strong. In the Transformers universe, they're going to pull you in with a little bit of something with the razzle dazzle, no pun intended, whatever. And then switch it because we don't know who the big bad is. They don't show them at all. I don't know. I like what I saw, but
Skydance is behind Bumblebee that stars Haley.
Steinfeld,
yes, yeah. And it was actually good. It's actually good, you know.
Yeah, I enjoyed that one.
Yeah, you take all the other ones because it's really a restart. You know, when it ends with Bumblebee talking to a hologram of Optimus, and it's the G1, it's the original, it's not the spruced up semi or anything like that. So it's the version we see here on this trailer. So I'll let them pull me in. I'm like, it's Transformers. You're talking to me. You're talking to my 80s self at this point. I'm just like, I'll ride with you. Let's see how this goes. You know, the first movie was fine. The second one was okay. But then after that, you started going off the rails and Tyrese had to yell every 5 minutes. I don't know. It was doing too much.
God.
And then, like, you started dumping everyone that we knew in it. And it was just like, yo, but nobody's getting no shine. So, no. I'm waiting to see how this. It looks good. It does. It really does.
Humans don't need no shine. I appreciate it. It looks like we got Anthony Ramos and Dominique Fishback.
Yeah, yes.
Love them both. So those are humans that we have to tolerate for a while. Cool. Yeah. But that last bit, it gives me... I don't want to overstate it. It's not on the same level. But remember the Infinity War trailer with the nasty fake out when everybody was rushing towards the camera?
Yeah.
Like, yes. Yeah, it's going to be epic. Like
we've never seen that rush.
That like, last bit of this trailer, it gives me that vibe of like, oh, you're actually going to have robots fighting robots in this movie about robots that have to fight other robots? Cool. Yeah. You might actually deliver on the thing is about? Awesome.
That always bugged me when they were crying about, what about the humans? I'm like, what about the humans?
What about them? It's Transformers. It's not about the show. Oh my God.
It's not called Transformers and the humans.
Yeah. It's Mark Wahlberg.
That's what happens when you, I guess you put him, you
see what happens, Sharon? You see what happens, Sharon, when you don't put me in? It's like, that's about as close as Mark Wahlberg as I can get. what do you say? It looks great. Seems to follow the Bumblebee movie. Yeah.
Yeah.
You almost have to be on the fence because, and not because of Bumblebee, because Bumblebee was great.
Yeah.
But because it wasn't done by Michael Bay neither. You have to be on the fence.
I'm looking it up. Stephen Caple Jr. So Creed 2 director.
He's dabbling.
Also, voices.
We know people Optimus coming.
Primal, Ron Perlman. Hellraiser, Michelle Yeoh.
Oh, shit.
Done. Say less.
Y'all with me now? I'm in.
It didn't take me much because you already got Peter Cullen. When you hit Ron Perlman, I'm like, oh, yo, what? Okay.
You had my interest. Now you have my attention.
So that works for me. I'm good with that. That interesting.
Michelle don't pick losers.
She has been in everything. No losses, and everything she's been in, I've loved.
Absolutely.
I'm just like, oh, she's doing that now. Oh, she's doing that now. Machine Gun Milkshake or Gunpowder?
Gunpowder Milkshake. Yeah. Yeah.
You had me when you said Angela Bassett. That was it right there. But then you said Michelle Yeoh. I'm like, oh, this is going to be one of those films.
Hello. Welcome.
I was like, and is women kicking ass? Oh, please, you ain't got the spoon feed it to me. Just give me the plate.
I could chew.
I was on board when he said Angela Bassett. I'm like, just give me the plate. Angela's, I don't care. Just, I want the plate. Give me the plate. You don't want to care. Give me the plate.
Stop playing it. It's playing around. Right.
It's like, there's nothing to talk about. You giving me what I need to see. So, that's actually an impression. This is something I'm noticing. And it's not just with animation on like with Invincible or anything like that. Or even He-Man on Netflix, the one by Kevin Smith. I'm noticing that they are really getting top tier A-list talent. Mm-hmm. To do a lot of voice work. It's not putting voice workers out of business, because they're still like Kevin Conroy was part of that camp. But you're seeing like lineups. You're just like, yo, this is a good lineup.
Yeah.
You know, so by will just like, we already knew Peter Cullen. Like, it's really, I don't see nobody else doing that. That's, it's hard. I mean, I know somebody can, because look at the Kevin Conroy situation. I know somebody can, but it's really to see anybody else do it. So when even with the first film, they said Peter Cullen's doing the voice, and I'm like, yo, he's still alive. You know, that was what I'm like. I was a kid. I'm like, this dude. I'm like, how old was he when it was on? You know, so I'm like, he's still doing it. Okay, fine, great. You know, so and then you say Peter Cullen and Ron Perlman. There's a lot of furniture moving in that room. Ron Perlman has one of those voices. It's like, it's just gritty. It don't matter what it is. It's just gritty and raw. And you know,
he could read a lullaby, and it turns into a nightmare.
Imagine the scene when these two back to back give whatever inspirational speech they need to give.
I really believe in myself. Scenery. I can take on a whole army by myself. Got me up in a movie theater like this when Peter Cullen gave that speech. I'm like, this motherfucker's spitting right now. He's spitting. What's wrong? He right.
We got to go do something. Okay, what? I don't know. We got to go.
We got to make sure it's good. I can... So, yeah, I'm looking forward to that. it, like I said, it speaks to the 80s kid in me, and it's just fun. It's fun to see stuff like that when they're going along with it and making sure it's right. Like, because when I first heard about it, I was really skeptical. Yeah.
Yes.
Tongue-tied there for a second. it happens to the best of us. But, you know, when they were just saying, like, they're bringing in Beast War characters, and I'm just like, will it work?
Please don't touch me in the no-no place.
Right, you know, like, you did this with the dynamite. Like, you know, y'all did, like, I didn't know who was behind it or anything. Like, I was just like, you did this with the Dinobots in the last one, and I'm just like,
please, no. No. You've gone too far.
Yeah, I'm like, I don't know, y'all. So,
yeah, it's hard to break that. It's hard to break. I mean, I've been hearing about the Beast Wars for decades.
Mm-hmm.
I never got to watch it, so I'm in because I want to know about the story about that. Hopefully they don't mess that up.
No.
But I know the fan base. I believe you. the fan base just around Beast Wars by itself is it's almost as intense as the OG Transformers.
Yeah. You figure if you take G1 Transformers, Beast War fans, Ninja Turtle fans, Power Ranger fans, those are like you're just like, you need to energy. Come in and you come in correct. Like, you come in correct. Like, they're like, you have too much content to say otherwise. You don't really necessarily have to make up this big elaborate story, but, you know, and then it's the 80s. So it's certain stuff you need to stick with. You know, we know storylines back then weren't as conducive as they are now.
Yeah.
You know, but when you do it, you got to come correct, which is why the G.I. Joe franchise didn't really kick. Like, they tried it and it didn't really kick.
It's bad. It's bad.
Other than Storm Shadow and Snake Eyes, it was, yeah. And then you turned around and tried to give us a Snake Eyes film, and I don't know what the hell.
So confused.
Yeah.
I was so confused. I'm like, wait, what? Who's the story about? Is this the Snake Eyes that was from the cartoon? What the fuck is going on?
Yeah. And Larry Hama, who created Snake Eyes, was behind. I'm like, well, what story are we telling? I don't know what's going on anymore.
No.
Like, is this a continuation from the G.I. Joe line? Are you rebooting it, starting with Snake Eyes? What are you doing?
What's going on? I just want someone to tell me what's going on.
Right. These are hard pills to swallow. Like, I knew G.I. Joe and G.I. Joe Retaliation are movies you can just sit back and let play in the background. It's not necessarily something you need to pay attention to. But when you made Joseph Gordon-Levitt Snake Eyes, and I'm like,
what?
Like, the drive behind everything was weird. Like, his sister was the Baroness. She used to date Duke, and then she decided to flip side. I'm like, yo, what is going on?
The fact that The Rock and surprise sprinkle of Bruce Willis couldn't save the film.
Right.
It's like, good night.
Like, you got Bruce Willis playing General Hawk, and I'm like, you had the cast. Somehow the story sucked. Except for the Snake Eyes and Storm Shadow angle. Those two angles were completely fine. And yet you didn't. The shine just wasn't there anymore. I don't know.
I didn't know they had to put The Rock in a jungle. Put him in a jungle, put him in some khakis. Would have made at least $10 million.
And let him smolder.
They didn't have the winning formula. Right. Almost. So close.
You let him smolder for a little bit. That's what you do. You know, so. This next one, and it's funny what Kira said. It was like, who believes this? Yeah, so, but I take it because, you know, it's a franchise character, you know, and I'm like, hey, if you build a good story around it, it's fine. You know, as long as you don't have the sun swinging with monkeys, you know, it's a hard pill to swallow. What am I talking about? I am talking about the new Indiana Jones 5 coming out June 30th. It's called Indiana Jones and the Dial of Destiny.
I love the alliteration.
Yeah. So let's see what this one is about. Let's see what this one is about. How did you say it? Who believes his oldest dirt ass is doing stunts?
Old as hell.
Not me.
Let's see where this goes.
I miss the desert. I miss the sea. I miss waking up every morning, wondering what wonderful adventure the new day will bring to us.
Those days have come and gone.
Perhaps, perhaps not.
I don't believe in magic. But a few times in my life, I've seen things. Things I can't explain. And I've come to believe it's not so much what you believe. It's how hard you believe it.
Who is this man?
I'm her godfather.
Related.
Get back.
Indiana Jones and the Quest for Metamucil.
Why are the guys at the end shooting like stormtroopers?
At the obvious nothing.
it's kind of what they do. It's kind of what they do. It's the obvious nothing. That's what it is. It's kind of what they do.
Okay.
I'm gonna let it. Shouldn't the movie be Indiana Jones and the lack of a 401k plan?
Indiana Jones and no tenure.
No tenure. Untenured. From what I can tell, it looks like they've de-aged him. So it looks like he's telling some stories,
yeah.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Or some stuff is being shown from, you know, past adventures. And it looks good. Yeah, it does. Yeah. It actually does look good.
It looks very pretty.
Yeah. So it looks like they may have learned some of their lessons from the last one.
I need them to explain the Crystal Skull. I need them to explain. Crystal Skull
was not an easy pill. Like, once you got past the beginning of the film, like where he's in that warehouse and everything, once you got past that, nothing else made sense.
No.
Marion made sense, but nothing else really made sense.
No.
You tried to tap into some of that nostalgia, but it just didn't switch over well.
I want to know how we got to this film instead of, I guess, swapping it out for Crystal Skull. Why didn't this story get told instead of Crystal Skull?
It's a good question. I know at the time when Crystal Skull was coming out, there was a crap ton of documentaries about Crystal Skulls. Like, it's an actual thing.
Yeah.
But not enough where, like, it's like you heard about it before the movie.
Yeah.
You know, I didn't hear about Crystal Skull. If you had said Area 51, then okay. But you didn't really do that. You tied it into it, and it was really loose. But I think after what scene was that? It was the nuclear bomb test scene. When he gets in the fridge, and I'm just like, all right, y'all jumped the shark, and it's just this movie is just starting. I get it. It's Indiana Jones. Sometimes that's what it takes, is jumping a shark. But that's a huge shark to jump at the beginning of the movie.
Of the movie.
I saw a position asking to replace Jump the Shark with Nuke the Fridge.
Nuke the Fridge.
In our vernacular.
I'm like, I like the fact that you talked about his friend Marcus, who the actor that played Marcus has actually passed away, and you gave a little homage to him. I like the fact that you brought Karen Black, I want to say is her name, back in to play Marion, you know, who we seen in Raiders.
Yeah.
So I like that you brought her back in and had some unresolved situations going on. You know, it's fine that you said, okay, she had a kid. That's fine. Did it need to be Shia LaBeouf? Well, he was kind of the it kid at the time. That's probably their way to go to it. I'm with you, Karen. I don't know why we didn't get this story instead of Crystal Skull. You know, I don't know who did the writing for Crystal Skull, but this version here, this trailer here, is already giving me like, okay, we're kind of going back to basics a little bit.
Yes.
You know, let's tell this story before he gets Harrison Ford's in his 70s.
Oh God, yeah.
You know, so
very much touching 70 if he's not in it.
You know, so you got to do something. You got to pass on this baton at some point. You know, at one point they was running around talking about Chris Pratt, you know, playing either his son or a younger version. I would have went with the younger version, but I don't know how well he would have pulled that off because
I don't like jokes.
Harrison Ford is like, DH me. I'll figure it out.
Yeah, with that energy you just said right there, like, because he has this gruff demeanor. Like, he doesn't really do jokes.
No.
Like, Indiana doesn't do jokes. He's about getting the business done. He's about finding the history, bringing it back home. He just gets embroiled in stuff that, you know, is, even he said it, is like kind of beyond explanation. And other than that, you know, other than that, it doesn't really care, you know. And he's just like, look, I'm just trying to teach a class. The only reason why I'm doing this adventure is I don't trust any of you to do exactly what I'm getting ready to do.
Right.
I don't trust you to go get the artifact, bring it back, and literally teach the history about the artifact.
Yes.
Because you guys will want to take it and sell it, and yes.
Because it belongs in a museum,
right? You're doing all this other stuff, so it, like, you know, and that's his passion. Like, every time you turn around, this man's teaching the class. I don't know where he finds time to do these adventures as a professor.
Isn't he going for like months at a time?
He's like, I need to go to India again
and just be gone.
Yeah, like, who's teaching the class?
Somebody else. Yeah. One of the kids will teach it.
Right. So. I you know, there was a time when it was really hot, when Indiana Jones was really hot. They had books about when he was younger.
Yeah.
They had a series about when he was younger. I liked that in the not Crystal Skull, the one with Sean Connery. Temple of Doom is not that one. It's the one with Sean Connery, which was the one with Sean Connery was his father. But
oh God,
I like the beginning because that was who played his young self. It wasn't
Phoenix. Was it River Phoenix? River Phoenix. Yeah.
Damn, it was that long ago.
But
that was a nice.
Yeah.
That was a nice little callback. Just a nice little adventure. It showed you where he got his scar on his jaw from, or from on his chin from. Show you where he got his name from, which was the dog. You know, and so it had a lot of notes to it that just like, oh, this is cool. I could watch a series like that because there's for somebody that's on so many adventures, you know, he didn't just start this as an old man.
The Last Crusade.
That's what it was. Yes.
It was itching me. Sorry. I had to look it up. Like, there's
I knew so one of us was going to get it. So, yeah, he said, yeah. In his class, they get it easier. He's like, I'll be gone for a couple of weeks. So, you know, everyone gets a, hey, I'll be back. Cool. I'm like, that's it? Okay.
Oh, God. I still remember the girl with the I love you written on her eyeballs. Oh my God. Oh, my God. It was like, I love you. It was so weird. It's so weird.
Yeah.
Anyway.
But yeah, so I'm, you know, I hold out hope. I'm looking forward to that. I like to see that. I want to see Indy get back to Indy. and have some fun. You know, it looks like whoever this actress is, seems like she's taking on a major role.
Oh, Miss Fleabag? Oh, wait a minute. You don't know about Fleabag?
Who's Fleabag?
Oh, baby. Let me tell you.
Please enlighten me.
Okay, first of all, I can't remember the woman's name. I want to say, hold on, I'm going to find it. But it is basically about this British woman. It follows her throughout her life, but she breaks the fourth wall.
Is this on Amazon?
Yes.
Okay, that's why it sounded like that. Okay.
I know we all about Blerd stuff, but let's
this
let
me is Blerd
just,
stuff.
Let me just
Phoebe Walker Bridge. White, yeah. That's her name. Phoebe Walker Bridge.
That white woman is funny.
Why do they have I know I seen Matt Mikkelsen in here. Yeah. I knew I seen Antonio Banderas. I knew that.
Oh.
Being a Nazi.
And Boyd Holbrook. I seen Karen Allen's in it?
Yeah, you said that.
No, in the last one, in Crystal Skull, she was in it.
Yeah, she's going to be. Why wouldn't she be in this one? She's going back in time, plus they had the whole kid.
Yeah, but they also have Shia LaBeouf listed.
Yeah, why wouldn't they?
Why would they? Why wouldn't
they? We have to talk about the elephant in the room, gentlemen. We have to talk. We have to acknowledge all of our good, bad, and ugly. We have to talk about it all. If we're going to talk about it all, we got to air it all out.
I'm going to put it like this. He really wasn't, for me, he wasn't a bad note in the film.
No.
It was when they had that big chase scene.
The Tarzan scene?
The Tarzan scene just it was too much. I'm just like,
it's pretty cool. You're gonna swing like you're in the jungle and you're just gonna swing like you're Tarzan. It's gonna be cool. Don't worry about it. We're gonna take care of it. Don't worry. It's gonna look great in post. We're gonna put all these extra 3D things in there.
It threw me off. It wasn't, and I stand correct. It wasn't Shia LaBeouf. It was just that scene, and it wasn't even the fridge scene. The fridge scene was just like, it's Andy. Let it go.
Right.
You know.
Right.
Look, this man survived a man digging his heart out and putting it back in. Kalima. It's Indy. Kalima. It's Indy. I let it go, you know? But the swinging monkey scene was just like, no. I can't do it. I couldn't do it. So, yeah. This next one. Actually, it's a continuation. We may not get all what we want to get out, but that's fine. That's not the holiday special. It's not the holiday special. Here it is. Guardians 3, Volume 3. Obviously, it's going to pick up after Guardians. Like I said, James Gunn is showing up a lot tonight. I'm going to just go ahead and play this because I actually like the Guardians trilogy. Well, I will like the trilogy because they have a fantastic soundtrack. Volume 1 and 2 has... Shout out to James Gunn because I found out, even with Peacemaker, I found out that he picks the music. So I'm like, oh, dude, no wonder. This stuff sounds amazing. So I can just imagine how the soundtrack is for this one. And... We'll talk about it.
We were gone for quite a while. But no matter what happens next, the galaxy still needs its guardians.
Hello, we come in peace.
Oh, dude.
No, 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 no!
Hey!
Don't forget where we came from.
We have been running our whole lives.
I'm done running.
Let the old be old.
all fly away together. One last time. Into the forever. That beautiful sky.
Kill a few people.
Kill no people.
Kill one guy, one stupid guy who no one loves.
Now you're just making it sad.
I have watched that trailer 5 times. Officially now, 5 times.
I gotta say, one, I'm just looking forward to this. Yeah. You know, for so many reasons. It is a very good mix of adventure and comedy and damn good one-liners and a soundtrack that is, I don't even know what the soundtrack is going to be. It's just previous entries have already shown, like, yeah, I'm fine. It's gonna be fine. Touching on that, I mean, we get a good look at Adam Warlock. Will Poulter is playing Adam Warlock. People were thinking, oh, not the goofy looking guy. And I'm like, but then you see, I actually seen picture. I'm like, you don't look nearly as dwarpy or anything as you did in certain movies, like Meet the Millers. Like, he looked twerpy as hell. That's the same guy.
I'm trying to remember what else he's been in, because the face that I see is the face that I know.
He might have been in Toy Story, because he looks just like Sid. I swear for Lord.
He did.
Before face, he looked like Sid.
He did.
This new man that I'm not convinced is Will Poulter. Like,
this dude here, he buff. He buff.
Give everybody abs.
Hair is all coiffed, and I'm like, women was tripping over him. I'm like,
they put him in the abs machine, and it also, you know, reconstructed his face. He got a strong jawline now.
And, like, I remember, I think it was DC that said it. He was like, oh, I think that's just a picture. And I'm like, no, dude, I've seen it. Like, he's done it, like, an interview. Like, he was not an interview, but he was coming out of somewhere. And I'm like, that ain't the same dude. What kind of glow up did you just have, my guy? Because I've seen you, like, in 2 or 3 other films prior to this. He was in Black Mirror, Bandersnatch.
That's what it is.
And he still didn't give off that vibe. But then I'm like, that's not the same. Did he have the Lanza app? I don't know. I just need to know.
He had a real life filter.
You know you're wrong.
I'm like, because he really didn't. Like, if you see any from Meet the Millers, you're like, that ain't the same dude.
The same program Kamel Nagiani did.
Also came up with a new hockey and everything. Like,
transformed. He went in there kind of funny and schlubby and came out. Cheekbone, like, chin.
I'm gonna try to find like a older picture. But why?
He's 29. He's a baby. He's a baby.
Yeah,
what, Mr. Miller? Mr. Miller was what, 10 years ago?
Yeah.
That dude, 29 from 19, your face changed. Well, except for me. But your face changes. I see the man that he's become.
he's just starting to get grown man weight in his face.
He's getting grown man weight in his face. That guy.
Oh my god, there's no chance.
That's fucking Sid.
It's all
that is exactly. That's it. Like that guy.
Or he had a little work done. Which
also, I appreciate Will Poulter, because he's heard people say that he looks like Sid. And one Halloween, he went as Sid, and it was amazing.
Okay,
it was Calvin Klein model.
Yeah, right. Like, there's no, he went from Sid to Calvin Klein model.
For real,
it's crazy. So I'm like, oh crap. So
session, Calvin Klein.
Shut up.
So we got Guardians on the mind. So, I've checked out Guardians of the Galaxy Holiday Special. It's 45 minutes on Disney Plus. I wanted an extra 20 minutes.
Yeah.
I really wanted an extra 20 minutes. This is honestly the team up I didn't know I needed. The team up I didn't know I wanted. And it was Drax and Mantis.
I need a 30-minute special of them at the bar.
I need
just 30 minutes of that.
So for those who are watching and listening, it's basically they're trying to they find out Sean Gunn. I can't think of the character's name because he's got Yondu's arrow now and stuff.
Kraglin.
Yeah.
He's telling them about how Peter, you know, since he's from Earth, he's been missing Christmas and all this other stuff and how it went, right? So Drax and Mantis decide, okay, we're going to give Peter a great Christmas. However, something else we find out, that Mantis is Peter's sister.
Like, okay, I think I talked to you about this. When did you know that?
Yeah, we didn't. We never did. We had no clue, like nothing. And now with when you look back, and this is what I mean about James Gunn dropping these little gems, because he did it with the Suicide Squad with Peacemaker, and then the Peacemaker would come out and you see these gems that you don't put together into, you're just like, I need to go back and watch stuff. So like in Guardians Volume 2, when she's like, I need to tell him something, you're thinking is about the whole plan that Ego had going, and you're in the moment. You're in the moment. It turns out that's not all she had to tell him. Turns out she's his half-sister. And I'm just like, Jesus Christ, I didn't see that coming.
No.
And then, so they go to Earth. Apparently, GoBots are a thing now in the MCU because they did something to Drax people.
GoBot killed his cousin or something.
I'm like, okay, we got GoBots in the MCU now. I guess this is a thing now.
Of all the fucking things, the toys in the world? All
the fucking things.
You've got the plethora of Disney shit. You picked a GoBot?
Yeah. They killed my cousin. I'm like, GoBots?
It's James Gunn.
Oh, wait.
It's James Gunn.
Wait, because they own Toy Story. Aren't GoBots in Toy Story?
I believe so.
That's okay.
I believe so. So we get this whole and you're right here. I want a whole thing with these two.
Just the bar.
And I've never seen Mantis like this, which is kind of scary. She's raising her voice because part of their Christmas gift is they're going after this hero that Peter always talks about. And it turns into the guy who saved the whole town with dancing.
Kevin Bacon.
It was Kevin Bacon. That was perfect. And he's saying, and so they go there and they have Kevin Bacon and they go there, and as they're chasing Kevin Bacon in his house, Mantis is so freaking scary.
That is terrifying.
Because she's screaming and she's popping or, hopping all through the house. I'm like, I would freak out.
Yeah.
Because we never seen her like
she
this.
Never fights. or tries to pursue anything, but I guess she's a praying man. Oh my God.
It's so crazy, but the bar scene that they have is absolutely hilarious. And it was a gay bar at that, so that made it even top tier at that point. I was like, oh, they went to a gay bar, had a blast, and got blitzed out their mind. I'm like, what kind of liquor did you two have that it affected you like that? Like, what did they give y'all? Because y'all
clear.
I'm like, the stuff y'all drinking out in space and in nowhere has got to be 10 times harder what they gave down here on Earth. So yeah, it was great. It was fun.
Hey, is that Will's new photo? Is that
Yes, he did.
Look, I knew it. He got sucked.
Oh, look at you. See, look, you were scared, but they hooked you up. You can trust technology sometimes, Will. I promise you, they don't leave you. Well, if it's human led,
he went and got that done. Look at it. He was like, oh, that looks real good.
It looks like you got your wedding hair picked out already. Go get it. Just hand him that picture.
So there's a lot of notes in this film. Horror film, this special, and this is the second of Marvel's special presentations. I need more of these. just nice little bridges, not bridges to other stuff. I need more. Yeah. I need to see more of these. This was a nice move for them.
Yeah.
You know, so that way you don't necessarily need a movie. You can get this hour-long special and then you can move on. It ties into characters. It doesn't tie into it, or it may tie into a particular thing, like this whole thing with Manus. We already know that's going into the movie.
Yeah.
Like by him saying that. But I have one big question. How the hell did Nebula get her hand on that?
Boy, he explained it. I'm like, oh, shit.
No, that was not. That wasn't. That is not it.
No, he being James Gunn, he explained it. There's an article.
There's a tongue-in-cheek explanation about that. And I've seen that. And I'm like, yeah, I don't see her just ripping that off. Like,
No.
He's got a Wakandan arm. He got a Wakandan arm. They gave it back to him.
That's the arm they would knock it off.
Right.
So I'm like, how did she get a hold?
Wait, is that the old arm?
That's his old arm. It looks like his old arm. So it could be the lighting, because it looked
like the original arm that he had.
Yeah, it was reflective. It was reflective because his new arm is black and gold. It's like a black and gold.
I thought it was the new one. I'll double check. But
yeah, it looked like it was the new. It looked like the old one. That's why I'm like, where did she get that? Like,
she walked up on Bucky with the pressure point pin code and just took
it. Right. Like, even Rocket was shook. He was just like, Bucky's arm? Yeah, my guy, somebody actually gave you a body part that you wanted and was gifted.
Possibly willingly?
I mean, it could be. Oh, you know, did she beat him in a game of paper football? I don't know. So it's like, he's like, I'm not doing anything with it. However,
I got this upgrade.
I got this upgrade, but you can have it. She's like, I'll, you know, fight you in a game of paper football. He probably just went ahead and was just like, okay.
If the next time we see Bucky is in the Thunderbolts and he just has a new arm and somebody asks him, he's like, I don't really want to talk about
that. I don't want to talk about that. I have no words.
Wait, fellas, I think you might be onto something here. I think you might be onto something. What is it? Valentina, she cutthroat. She might trade some stuff to get some stuff.
I mean, last time we see a remote version of his arm, it's in Civil War. And it got ripped off.
The broker.
Power broker.
The power broker.
Son of a bitch.
I'm like, I know somebody got that arm from him. Cause that ties right into the TV show.
But what is the exchange? What are you getting back for this arm?
Something from Thanos? Or Thanos related? Or, because isn't, and I don't know, this isn't.
She could have gave her, she could have gave her a piece of tech that she already has, a gun, anything, that they don't have.
Also, didn't in Ant-Man, Kang had something stolen from him, right?
He has.
It's Bucky's arm.
Bucky is in the middle of all of it. No.
I can't. Maybe.
All this time we thought it was Strange that messed up the timeline. We thought it was Wanda. All this time it was Bucky.
It was Bucky. It's always Bucky.
It's always the damn colonizer. Oh, God. What did you think? What did you think of the special care?
I liked it. It makes me all the more sad that James Gunn is leaving. It was clean.
It is clean.
I think there's a couple of points where I was like, all right, enough with the jokes. let's get to the story. Like, I know what you're trying to do here, and yes, it's funny. It's a holiday movie. Cool, fine, bye. I thought it was pretty good. The music. But everything else was totally fine. His friends playing being the band. Yeah. I mean, of course you're gonna put his friends in the movie.
Why not?
Yeah. Why not?
You want to be in a movie? Sure, why not? What do you need to do? I tell you what, you can play one of your songs.
Yeah.
Even Steven.
Balance, baby, balance. Keep there that budget is. Keep that budget low, too.
Apparently, he can do that.
Who knew? Just be nice to people. They might just do shit for free.
Exactly. I know a guy that knows a guy. That's how Nebula got the arm. I know a guy that knows a guy.
It works.
So, Will, what did you think?
I really enjoyed it. Having Mantis have room to actually stretch her legs as a character was great, because she does a lot of like little really funny shit, but you got to be paying attention to her character specifically. Mm-hmm. Like, I forget which one. I forget which point in Guardians, but Peter said something like, put your angry face on or your game face.
And she makes that. She does that.
So it was great.
I don't know the scene you're talking about.
It was great letting her get some run. And also, I thought it was going to be weird at some point having Drax and Mantis, where neither one of them is really the straight man, but like, it worked. I was entertained thoroughly for 45 minutes.
Yeah. It makes no, I'm looking, because I'm like, I could have swore she was in the Suicide Squad. There's a scene when they go to a bar.
Yeah.
And she's dancers or the singers that's on the stage. Yeah. She's the main singer, if I'm not mistaken, that's on the stage. And I'm like, I'm looking, and I'm like, wait, she was in Thor, Love, and Thunder? I'm trying to... Oh, yeah, she was. Okay, never mind. Poor Thor, Love, and Thunder. Good Lord. I didn't know it was that forgetful.
that will shall not be named.
Yeah.
Hashtag never forget.
Yes. Mantis and Drax made the special. They did. You know what? Nobody's talking about the other elephant in the room. How the hell did we get frat boy Groot?
Groot is swole.
That's what I'm saying. Like, that's frat boy Groot.
Why he thick? Fuck. Why is he so,
like, my swole. Guy came in. I'm like, yo, what kind of weights are you hitting?
Yeah.
I'm like, you didn't. I'm like, was he in Love and Thunder? I don't recall you looking like that.
It was unnerving. That was the only thing that I had, like, I don't want to see no more of him on the screen, and I'm glad y'all decided to not put him on. He looked like a pit bull with a tree head.
I'm like, he's hitting that. Is that that? He's, we get it. He's a teenager, so he's probably 20s ish, earlies, you know. So he's like, he's bulk,
stocky, bulk, just wide.
Like, my man is the frat boy, and like, he just got done hazing somebody. I'm like, I don't know. It's just like, my guy is just.
It weird.
Groot went through the same program as Will Poulter.
Right. Oh my good God. It's crazy.
Oh damn. They saw this. But,
yeah, sorry. I do. I really do need. I wish Gunn was here long enough to give us a couple specials from that team, because it's nice to see. You know, and not, and here's the beauty: Peter wasn't the forefront.
Right.
And that, and it's no slight to him. It's just, it was nice to see Drax and Mantis. You know, let's see. I want to see another story. Let's see that story, how Nebula got that damn arm. Mm. You know, let's go there for a little bit, you know. Let's see a little background thing where, you know, I like seeing Rocket and Groot interact, because there is that father-son dynamic, you know. So let's get those two more stories, and we're fine. I'm fine. I really do. I want that backstory in Nebula. What happened? You know, they left, and you're just like, I have something to do. And since you're Nebula, nobody questions it. They
going.
I'm leaving, you know? Okay. So, yeah. We need a Rocket and Nebula short. We do need a Rocket and Nebula short.
Yeah.
Now that, that would be fun.
Oh, yeah.
I can see those two at the bar. Those two for real at the bar.
Oh my god, drinking heavy, Rockets and in the back in the bar, back snatching shit. Holy god,
drinking heavy and getting into a whole ass bar fight. Exactly. That I need. And that's how she gets the arm. oh my god. So I guess we got a little time. We'll crush this out. You guys want to do it?
Yeah.
Wednesday? Okay, let's crush it out. Oh. All right. So Netflix has an 8-episode series called Wednesday, based on Wednesday Addams from the Addams Family mythos. Here we are. Jenna Ortega is playing the part of Wednesday. It looks like we are going to get a season 2. I'll let Kira go first, then Will, then I'll tell my piece. So go ahead.
I don't like this show. I don't. No. Everybody around me tells me that they love it. They think it's so cute. Blah, blah, blah. Wednesday's not cute.
She's gothic cute.
No. Wednesday's about her shit. She's cute. She reels you
she's
in.
She's definitely about her shit. I'm not going to. Yeah.
This Wednesday, I ain't with it. I don't fuck with this Wednesday. I don't care.
No. We've never gotten this Wednesday. This Wednesday is what, 16? Well, 15 going into 16.
Yes.
We've never gotten this Wednesday. We've gotten like a 10, maybe 12 euro Wednesday, maybe even 13.
Okay, fine.
Attempted murder.
That ain't it.
Water polo team.
That's one instance. I need more. Like Wednesday.
Oh, you need more. You need more that Wednesday.
Yes. I mean, deadly as fuck Wednesday. Murdering these hoes out here in these streets.
Man lost a testicle.
And he was soft. That'll make him swim faster. He don't have no more drag time. That was a benefit. Listen, she helped the team. He go shave at least 0.2 off of his time.
So let's talk. So you didn't like the show. You didn't like nothing about the show, or was it just certain portrayals?
I like Jenna Ortega as Wednesday. Mm-hmm. I did not like the iteration that I feel like they nerfed Wednesday.
Okay. Mm. That's fair. Nerfed her in the sense that because Baby Wednesday from the TV series, mm-hmm. we don't really.
No, I'm not counting that. I'm not counting that.
The Christina Ricci version we get is the one that everybody really loves because she shoots for this version of Wednesday, shoots straight from the hip.
Yeah.
Christina version shoots straight from the hip. Mm-hmm. She says the same lines, but she does the actions as well.
Yeah.
And we didn't. I get what you're saying.
Yeah.
She says the lines, but other than the piranha scene, we don't get too many of the because she's. But then again, she's more growing into herself. Is the best way to put
that,
it.
But that's the thing. Wednesday is not unsure about herself.
Mm-hmm.
She's not. She comes up with a plan. It doesn't even take her that long to come up with a plan to take somebody out. I think you know what it is? I'm stuck on movie Wednesday.
Okay. That's fair. That's fair.
But wasn't that a PG-13 movie too?
Yes.
Give me that Wednesday. Give me that Wednesday.
I think what they wanted to do, it would have been too tongue-in-cheek. I guess is the best way to say it. They had to build something around. I like the fact that she's at Nevermore. I like the fact that she's trying to solve several things, actually. I did at first have a problem with Luis Guzman's portrayal. And then I had to take a step back and realize it's not about him or the family.
Yeah.
It's about Wednesday.
Wednesday.
I also had to take a look at the fact that compared to John Astin's role and Raul Julia, rest in peace, that man, he killed that shit. But also the comic strip, he looks the part.
Yeah.
And John Astin's role, he's very oafish. Mm-hmm. You know, Morticia says something, he just trips over his feet. Yeah. Like, yeah, he loves his wife.
Yes.
Luis Guzman's version, loves his wife, yes. loves his family. He yes. will do anything for him. And this is obviously apparent.
And whatever Morticia says fucking goes.
Like, exactly. He will not.
There's no other school. There's no other school for Wednesday. We're leaving at this time with this car, with this amount of clothes for you to go to this place because Morticia said so. That's it. Yes.
Yeah. You know, he loved he, I don't want to say spoiled, but he spoils.
He dotes on his love of his life.
Yeah, and he does, and his wife is the love of his life. His family is the love of his life.
Yeah,
you know. So I had to take a step back and look at it from that angle. And I'm like, okay, we're so used to Raul Julia, who was like boisterous and loving at the same time, but then we forget there's that scene where in the second movie, where, you know, the baby is missing or the baby's going through all this stuff and his brother and he's like, he's lazy. He's moping around the house. He ain't who he's supposed to be.
Yeah.
And you're just like, okay. So I had to look. It was just weird seeing Luis Guzman play that. And then I'm like, well, he is. He normally does play oafish. You know, we don't see... He does. Like, everything you see Luis Guzman in, it's kind of an oafish role.
He's a drug
comedic. He's a comedic. He's comedic. And Catherine Zeta-Jones, she slayed it, number one. She just looks
amazing. No, so. There's... nope. Just, no notes.
You killed it. Never mind.
Yeah, you good girl. You could come back anytime. Matter of fact, can we get you in the show?
I did want Pugsley to be a little more. I'm not used to him being bullied.
What was that?
That was by his sister. Yes.
Yeah.
But by school people, like if I can see if. They got the upper hand. He got put in the locker.
That's still
but
weird.
But then he turns it, but then, and it's still weird. But then he turns the tables on them.
Right.
You know, not being
like, you're gonna put me in a locker, I'm gonna put you in a morgue.
Yeah. Not being, you know, not getting snatched out by his sister and then basically getting, I mean, she would do that.
Yeah.
But just, you know, having him almost sniveling, and it was weird. And it's nothing against the actor, it's just I wasn't used to seeing Pugsley ever like that.
Yeah,
the Pugsley I got used to see, that I was used to seeing, was when they were at the lake and he's tossing grenades in the lake to go fish. Yep. I'm used to that kid,
right?
That, not the bullying. It was really
Pugsley
really
would have been the one to put the piranhas in the pool, not Wednesday.
Yeah,
Wednesday would have gave them would have poisoned them in some way, shape, or form.
Yeah. Yeah, he says shooting for the modern and not wanting to go back to the movie version. We all know it was a gamble. It was a true gamble.
I just don't like the fact that they did it was Wednesday meets Riverdale.
It was.
It chaps me.
I've never watched one episode because when I seen what it was about, I'm like, I've seen Archie stuff before, and I'll sit that one out. You know, I'll just sit it. And then I thought about getting on board because then they brought Sabrina in, and I'm like, should I watch it now? I don't know, but it is. That was kind of a gamble. Will, what you think?
Nah, like to Kira's point, I was watching. I was like, oh, so this is what it would be like if Tim Burton had his own CW show. This is fun. This is fine.
Yeah,
but I did enjoy it. I lost my shit at the dance scene. I was like, what is happening? Is this why, you know, the other side doesn't rhythmically allow themselves to just go? Because
number one, the Addams Family are Hispanic. There's flavor over there.
A little sazon.
It was a little hip roll. I recognize that as a dance move.
I'm glad you mentioned that, because we're gonna look at this little scene. This was a fun scene.
Oh, yeah. I turned into a teenage cougar pup. Yeah, I cruise through the city and I roam the streets. You better duck when I show up. I'm the night head hunter looking for some head. Well, away our body underneath that head.
Cause I'm a teenage tiger and a
There we go. There you go, girl.
Now, I'm going to tell you right now. She outdanced everybody on that floor, including that dude. He didn't know what to do.
Who didn't know what to do to that?
He didn't know. When you see, because they didn't.
She was possessed.
When he starts swaying, I'm just like, dude, don't do it. You're done.
You're gonna lose an eye.
You're done. You're like, you can't match it. You can't match the energy. Like, all you can do is sit there and stand there and smile and look like a goofy idiot. You can't do anything. What did he say? Well, and she choreographed that, as a matter of fact. She did. What's going on, Mike? They showed a split second of her doing the original meme from that Wednesday dance from the original series where she's dancing with Lurch. She busted out that scene. And I think if the camera, she probably did it longer. It's just what the camera caught, you know? So Pulp Fiction vibe.
I wish they had put that in there.
Yeah. I think it probably is like more to it. I would love to see it because I'm like, yeah, she said she choreographed that scene. The dance scene and everything. And I'm just like, you know what? I'm with it. I was with it. I was just like, it looks awkward, yet it's on beat. Everybody else ain't on beat. Everybody else is like, because that boy was stuck. Shout out to Gwendolyn Christie.
Oh, man. She's winning. I like it for her.
She really is. And it kind of broke me. It did. It broke me when she did an interview and she says this is the first time she was able to be on screen and be beautiful. Like we're used to seeing her, you know, from Game of Thrones as Brienne of Tarth, and she was, you know, making her look very homely and she's in armor all the time and everything else. But if you've seen her at premieres and at these functions, she's absolutely gorgeous.
She murders at any premiere that she goes to.
Sandman. She killed it.
We had opulence of the devil.
I'm like, I see why you would fold and you know, statuesque, very attractive, you know. Yeah, I see how it works. It's generally how it works.
And also, she doesn't, she has feminine and masculine features.
Mm-hmm.
It works for her. Like she could do, yeah. I forget what the term is, but
she was killing those outfits. She was killing those outfits.
Androgynous, yes.
Yeah, she was killing those outfits, you know, and the platinum blonde is just, it kicks. It kicks right. It kicks right. So it's a shame that we won't get her for another season unless they find something kooky. Cause I mean, it is like the version of Hogwarts you never thought you would see, but
That is true.
Fred Armisen as Uncle Fester. Pure gold.
Yeah. I mean, without question, him, that I loved. That I loved.
I did. For you to bring him back for one episode and he shows up, shows out, and in that same episode, your heart drops. In that one scene, well, two scenes, because you didn't know where that was going to go. When Wednesday comes back to her dorm and Thing is stuck against the wall with a knife. And I'm just like, yo, please, nothing.
No. We ain't playing that game today.
I'm like, nothing. Come on.
You killed a cat. You just killed a dog on screen.
Yeah. And you see how she reacted. Despite everything, because you know she was really even Thing. It's weird saying how even Thing told her pretty much like, I'm not doing another thing for you till you apologize.
Yep.
You know, and she pretty much apologized, you know, and he was like, yeah, this is about as far as I've ever gotten with this, so I'll take it. And what's up, Montel? All the way from PAX Unplugged. What's going on? I hope you're having a blast.
Hey, Monty. Uncle Monty.
But just seeing that and then coming in when she comes in and like she could, like that Wednesday we're used to seeing, that Wednesday's gone. Because she seemed like she really does care for Thing. And to see Thing in that, to see Thing in that position, and just like everything went.
The ongoing family with the Addams family is they care about their family, each and every one of them, ride or die for their family. You do not mess with anybody in the house.
Yeah, and that's what I love about it. And the fact that she ran him over to Uncle Fester. First thing came out about doctor, patient on the table. Like it switched up that fast.
Oh, look at you! You got a bot. Look at you!
Oh my God! Look at this!
Look at it? On the you. YouTube You're channel. Getting famous. Yeah.
Oh my God! My hot
photo here.
Ooh, oh, hi!
I thought that was Montel. I thought he was saying he had a new photo.
No, I was like, wait a minute.
That was Will after he did his AI.
Blocked this daggone thing. I'm like, I can't have this. Oh my God! But I have to do like block this crap. But yeah, it's mute that there over there. There we go. So. Seeing a lot of this stuff play out, and seeing the whole thing with Thing and Uncle Fester, season two is going to give us Cousin It. You got to.
I don't want to. Why didn't we get Cousin It now?
Well, I know he doesn't live with them. He does pop up.
I think they just wanted to keep it more heavily focused on Wednesday. Because it is just Wednesday. It's not an Addams Family show.
They could have like a little bit hair.
Because they were like doing promo and one of those pictures was his.
Right. That's why I'm confused. So
I'm like, was it something we missed?
Is there going to be a post credit scene or like a mid
storyline out?
Right. I'm waiting for it.
Also, one thing that just popped back up in my head. Thing is an actual actor. It's not just a CGI. Mm-hmm. It's a dude in a blue suit.
Yeah.
I'm like,
it's a hand magician they got from, I think it's Germany.
Is it the same guy that did? No, it's not the same guy.
No, it's not the same guy.
He's too young.
Yeah, not the same guy.
Yeah.
But, you know, so shout out to that person. I cannot remember his name. But they did a fantastic, in my opinion, they did a really good job with the topic they had. However, and nobody spoke about this one yet, I'm surprised. Joy Sunday. No, who?
I thought you were about to talk about the monster being ugly.
Oh, no.
Sorry. Go ahead.
Joy Sunday. Bianca. I fell in love with Bianca.
I need her in more things.
Yes.
Yeah.
I need her in Wakanda. I need her to be in the Dora Milaje series.
She was giving.
I want her to be in the next Sandman season.
Yes. Yes.
I don't know
Literally all the things.
Yeah, all the things. And the fact that people were kind of like, okay, yes, they made her seem like she was the mean girl in the beginning, you know, and it turns out she's so more layered. There was so much more going on. And I'm like, thank you. Tim Burton, it's not that hard. And she's proof of it.
Who's the writer? I know it wasn't Tim Burton. Who was the writer?
So that's that thing about you don't know how to write black people. Just say that.
Wait a minute. Charles Adams, Miles Millar, and Alfred Goh.
Millar and Goh, that's why. That's why.
Gotham. Yes. What else?
Damn near everything, kick ass.
Yes.
Yeah. So there.
Oh.
So,
who knew?
Seeing her on screen just gave all types of black girl magic. I was just like,
more, give
this
over here, right here, this table here,
and she saves the day.
Thank you. Wait, well, I mean, okay. Jeez. All right. I won't go into my thing, but okay.
Don't go into it.
I'm so tired of being, what is it, magical black person. I don't want to be magical black girl.
She is magical. And she is the black girl.
Be literal. can't we just be like, oh shit, yeah, no, I'm gonna go over here and preserve my life in this direction. Y'all had this, y'all been on this since day one, right? All right, cool, bye.
But she also was very smart. Like when they caught old boy and Wednesday was going torturing for info, she was like, all right, I didn't sign up for this, I'm gone.
Yeah,
that is the correct response. Can I get black girl magic for 100, please, Alex? Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, I want Snoke. This ain't me.
This is the action we always take. You know?
Yeah.
You said heavy is the hand. The whole
heavy character. Is the one.
Oh, my God. But yeah, I really did. I enjoyed her character.
Yeah.
I need to see more. And I know we're getting, you know, unfortunately with Netflix, they just take forever to do. Seasonal shows, they just do. You know, if you said okay next year, perfect, get the work,
yeah, just
pump it out.
You know that, you know what you have. I mean, I mean it's also scheduling, I guess, with actors, and
it could be because I believe Jenna's you're filming another Scream, and I believe she's in it, and it's taking place in New York opposed to Woodbury. Look, folks are still going to see Halloween. Folks are still going to see Scream.
Not in the theater. Oh God, why? Why?
Neve Campbell's not in it, so because
I bet she ain't.
She was like, look, I done told y'all time and time again, and I watched that movie. I watched it on cable a couple weeks ago. So because I was like, it was on. I'm like, good. I ain't got to pay for it. I can watch it.
It facts. So, more and more facts.
So. And literally, she's literally telling them, double shot in the face, keep it moving, don't split up, don't do this. And they did completely the fucking opposite. except for Dewey. He did go in there to make sure, but I'm like, dude, you forgot. You should have done that before you walked out the door.
No, I'm not. No, don't give Dewey a pass. Yeah. Don't give that. Action. No,
I didn't give him a pass. He should have done that before he left. Not get everybody.
Nobody asked you to go back in, my guy.
I gotta go back in and do it. And they were like, why? He was like, double shot. I'm like, dude, you should have done that before you left.
Guys, I got it. Since we're moving Scream's location, it's in Atlanta. It's called Scrum, directed by Tyler Perry.
Scrumped.
That's
scrumped. Scrumped. I ain't scrumped a scrumped like that before in my life.
Oh my God.
The scream, I just scrumped.
Oh, you know what? It's funny you mentioned Tyler Perry. As much as Tyler Perry, you know, just he does give content.
Don't he?
It's not always great.
No.
But you keep black folks working. It's this weird balance thing he's got going on.
I don't want to.
But he did sign a deal with Amazon recently, and I think it's like a 4-picture deal. Yeah, matter of fact, yeah, I think it's a 4-picture deal.
No, I don't want any more media. I don't want any more.
He just visits like this. No,
go away.
I will say he just said it. He's like, he is the master P of pushing out movies. Yes. That was an era I do not want to live in again.
Oh my God. He won't stop.
It was like, I'm like, we asked for black movies.
We weren't specific enough.
Jordan Peele gets it. He knows what's going on.
He knows what time it is.
He said black people in horror movies that live, say less.
We must be clear in our affirmations.
Yeah, right.
Yes, should have like, said less shucking and driving and a little bit more.
We didn't get you in the right space. And that's, I think that's us. That's us, right?
Yes, I said it. I meant what I said.
That's us. That's, I think we'll take that. Live your dream, my man. Live your dream.
The chitlins, stop serving the chitlin circuit. You don't have to deserve them. I'm tired. as tired. So.
I'm like, I would rather you do. This is what's weird. about Tyler Perry films. A lot of his features tend to be a little better than, like, the shows are weird. My wife watches like three of them.
Did you not see the episode of Atlanta?
I did. I did. And so it was just, I'm just like, oh, you won't come down on my man like that, huh? Mm-hmm. But you was gonna come down on the Boondocks when they was pointing it out too, right? They still get flack for that episode. I'm like, look, the whole purpose of the Boondocks was to poke fun at everything. So what is truthful? It's called comedy. That's what
exactly.
Laugh. Oh my god. We're obviously going to get a season two of Wednesday.
Yes.
Shout out to Jenna Ortega. Shout out to Joy Sunday. Shout out to that cast.
Yeah.
Hopefully we get Cousin It in the second season and more.
They can't be fucking around. They can't fuck around.
You got to bring in Cousin It. I don't care if that's the second and last season. As long as you bring in Cousin It and solidify this stuff, we're fine.
How are they going to do it?
It's Cousin It. Cousin It always shows up. My man he's a jet setter. That man go anywhere, he pop up the man is Snoop Dogg, for Christ's sake.
Yeah, why? Why did that happen?
I've watched those, and people have talked about like who would be best played for if they had to choose for Gomez Adams. Johnny Depp was one. I can see it.
Younger.
Oscar Isaac is a damn good pick because he's done the voice already. Pedro Pascal.
Sand Daddy.
You got Aqua Daddy, Aqua Poppy, now Sand Daddy. Okay. Sand Daddy. But yeah, Oscar Isaac was a good pick. And Pedro Pascal was also a good pick. More Oscar Isaac.
Yeah,
I'm not gonna lie. Just because I like Pedro Pascal too. He's the man. But I do like Oscar Isaac.
He hams it up better.
Yeah, that's what it is. That's what it is. And I'm like, okay, that's cool because you know, somebody else was mentioning Johnny Depp and Ava Green, and I'm like, okay, we've seen that matchup in Dark Shadows. So we've seen that before. Yeah.
I didn't watch that movie.
Dark Shadows? Yeah. No. Check that one out.
All right.
It's a Tim Burton movie, but it's based off a actual soap opera.
The lore and stuff around it, or the history around it, I do know. I just never watched the movie.
Yeah.
Like I know it's very dry humor.
It is. I mean, it's what you expect. It's Tim Burton, it's Johnny Depp, it's Ava Green. Chloe Moritz, Grace, Johnny Miller, Helen Bonham Carter,
of course.
Mm-hmm.
Well, yeah, the Holy Trinity.
The normal crew, right? And so it's just how you expect. You know, people were like, "Oh, it's horrible." And I'm like, "What?" I'm like, "Come on, it's have you seen the original soap opera?" I'm expecting ham. You know,
they do. It's extra pork.
Like I remember my grandparents telling me about this because when cable was really expanding and they had one network called soap.net.
Oh yeah.
And they would show all these soap operas, and that was their main one. They started there showing Dark, and I had never heard of it. And I remember my mother and my grandmother saying, "Yeah, this is about vampires and werewolves." And I'm like,
"Oh,
no, you're telling the kid this." And I'm like, "I'm sold."
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I'm watching it and realize I'm like, okay, it's old, whatever. But then I'm like, yo, this is cheesy, like organs playing when it's something dramatic, and like they're telling me about this Barnaby character, and I'm like, well, okay, so when this movie comes out with Johnny Depp, and I'm like, okay, I've seen a couple campy episodes of the original. I'm expecting the same type of camp. And that's what I got. I'm like, it's a campy film. It's like when you say, oh, it's about this vampire, or this about this man. He got turned into a vampire and lost the love of his life, and he's buried alive because of a witch, and it's a whole thing. It's a whole thing.
I'll watch it tonight. I'll watch it tomorrow.
Yeah, and they say, oh, and they bring him back. They bring him back present day. Their present day at the time was like the 70s.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I'm like, oh, you really going for the camp? It's in the 70s? Yeah, you're going for the camp. You know, wild dress and everything else. And, yeah. And I'm just like, it was horrible. What was bad about it? It was too goofy. Did you hear the premise of the movie?
Were you not there?
So, it had a lot of stuff. Before we get out of here, I wanted to say Netflix seems to be getting back on track. Well, can we keep this train going a little bit? It's not enough. Not enough, but you know, some of the content you've been dropping has been watchable. It has been, you know, it hasn't been horrible, you know.
I've forgotten to cancel my subscription in between months, the last 2 months. Oh. So it's
yeah, they actually have some pretty good things on there. Even some of the stuff that you would never like normally wouldn't watch because it doesn't star anybody we know, but it's like a lot of overseas stuff. That stuff tends to be good, pretty good.
Can we get some good content without another price hike?
Yeah, that's, you know. I mean, we are getting a movie with The Rock and Chris Evans. Yeah.
Oh god. Oh wait.
Yeah, see, I knew it would change.
Conflicted.
Oh wait.
People's champ with America's ass. I mean, oh, what do you?
Good lord! Ooh, double booty! Ooh, there is double booty beauty! Ooh,
double beauty! Here is making sure she has her subscription active for that month.
Exactly. Oh my goodness! So, but yeah, it does. They do have some content that is like, okay, I'll watch that. You know, I'll check that out. I'll see this. You know. My wife watches a lot of foreign action films now, and some of these series are pretty good. Like their procedural dramas, they're pretty good. This one I still haven't gotten through, but it's RRR, and it's like 3 hours long.
Dude, no, that shit's good.
I know.
No, get into it.
What I call, because the only reason why I didn't get it is because watch it all is because I actually had to leave. But what I was watching, I'm like, yo. I'm like, I need to see more of this.
Finish that off, man. Do yourself a favor.
So yeah, it's stuff like, so I'm like, okay, you have some content. You're not pushing it. It's getting pushed out by word of mouth. You know, what was the one Ryan Reynolds did? The Adam Project. I think that was.
Yeah.
That was nice. Yeah, that's a good one. That kid is actually playing Percy Jackson.
Right.
For the series, you know, and that kid's good.
Yeah.
He
was holding his own with Ryan Reynolds. He wasn't hamming it up. It wasn't too.
He was Ryan Reynolds.
Yeah, he got it.
I'm like, yo, this kid, like, they show a behind the scenes shot that they were doing, and Ryan was recording him. Like, they were sitting in the car, and he was recording in the kids in the back seat, and he's reciting the entire opening line to the first Deadpool film, word for word. And Ryan is just like, he's surprised, but then when he started hearing the curse words, he was like, oh, like, Ryan, you said it. What would you think the kid was doing?
You already know he saw the movie. He saw the edited version.
He actually said, he was like, I didn't know if I was more impressed that he knew the lines or that he knew that he's seen the movie to know the lines. So it was one of those things. So it's Ryan Reynolds. He's always a joy.
Never miss.
Never misses. All right, so let's get out of here. Kira, we'll start with the lady of the evening.
Oh, well, thank you. Hi. Yes. Oh, Lord. I grew a beard. Sorry. Hormone therapy. Sorry.
I gotta remember, it's always the upper left.
I am on... wow. Hi, good evening. It's me, a person that has things that she does. I am on Fanbase at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I have an audio room every Saturday. If you ever want to come through and talk about some nerd stuff, it's usually starting off with the event of the week we'll go into, but we definitely dive into a plethora of things. It gets interesting. My handles on Twitter, on Instagram, and now on Hive are Room Full of Blerds. Check me out. I got some nice stuff on there. I can get some scoops.
Sometimes. Oh yeah. Will.
Yes, sir. We'll be watching The Cinematic Assassin. I am everywhere I need to be. That is Instagram, Twitch, Twitter, and live on Hive now at Mayhem Media. That's M-A-Y-E-H-E-M Media. Check your boy out. We talking about movies, TVs, comics, whatever the hell I want to, really. So if you want to have a good time, find me.
All right. It's yours truly, the man on the wall, Chris Fury. Hello, everyone. Before we get out of here, there is one little piece of news that came across my time. And I don't know how I feel about this. WB is nearing a deal with Amazon to stream animated projects.
No, wait. Wait.
I don't know how I feel about that.
Why isn't it going to HBO Max?
That's what I don't know why I don't feel how I feel about that.
They're going to send their B stuff to them.
They might keep the other stuff,
but Warner Brothers, they might send
them a couple movies,
maybe, but the movies.
That's their
wheelhouse.
Yeah, I'm like, yo, don't do this to me.
Don't do that. Don't do that.
Please don't do this to me.
I like this. Not like
this. No, just keep that train going. Just please. but. Ooh. It's so weird to me. I don't know how I feel about that one. Chris Fury, man on the wall, the man up north. You can catch me on Blerd's Eye View on the IG channel. And if you go there, you can catch the link tree in the bio. One of those link trees will lead you to the Blerd's Eye View podcast on Facebook. You can also listen to us on Opulence Radio. If you get the Opulence Radio app, you can listen to us all day Tuesday and past episodes, and all day Thursday from past episodes. You also can check us out on Twitch, Blerd's Eye View 1. And you can just find us every Tuesday at 8:30 p.m. and every Thursday at 9 p.m. Facebook, YouTube, Twitch. I myself am also on Hive under Chris Fury. Black Twitter is dying.
No, they're just relocating. Just relocating.
Yeah, they're just relocating. They're trying to get the bugs worked out. That's what we're trying to do. You know, but Black Twitter was such a joy. It's like, wherever it went down at Black Twitter. Like, parts of Black Twitter still exist. Like, there's something going on with Good Morning America with the two co-anchors.
Oh,
and that got me. Okay, I would just say
it. Child,
this was so funny to me. These two anchors who are already married are involved with each other. Private investigator called them. However, that little piece of news came out before, because Pam Grier, I think she wrote a book, and it was called, I think it wasn't In the Thick of It or something to that effect.
But you don't say.
Yeah, exactly. It came out. And she was like, it's a great team to work with. And that wasn't behind her. And we're just like, it's a shame that came out like an hour after people found out about these two anchors dealing with each other. And now it's all these little videos just popping up. And it's like,
yikes.
Whoopsie.
So funny. It was so funny. And I couldn't stop laughing. Like, oh, we gotta, who is this? Mastodon. I need to get my Mastodon account together.
Let me know when you do. I can't figure that damn thing out.
Yeah, I got it. Yeah, same. That's why I gotta figure it out. I'm like, this. It's layered. It shouldn't be layered. What's going on? I just want to get in there and start talking trash.
Yeah.
So
give me the tea.
All right, that's all I want. I want the tea. What are you here for? The tea. Oh my god. All right, we're getting out of here. Tune in Tuesday. Also, January 14th, 15th, and 16th, Blerd's Eye View will be a part of the Guinness Book of World Records longest video podcast. We'll be posting up for, we'll be doing a show for 1 hour. So everybody gets an hour slot. Kira, I got to get you that link. I sent you the link.
You sent me the link. I got it.
Yeah. And I gave it to Will too. So you might see. It might be an hour from, it might be an hour for other people, but I'll be with What the Shit. I'll be with Blerd's Eye View. So I'm already doing 2 hours. So I'm like, I'm doing a show, then getting off and doing another show. It's called Press Tour, baby. But if you would like to check it out, hit up my man, Darius DC Chambers, or Amaron Burnett, who's also our, who runs Opulence Radio. You want to hit her up. Just check the post. I'll be sharing it pretty soon. It's for a good cause. It has a charity attached to it. You really want to do something like this. If you have a podcast, if you want to come out there, you want to talk, you get an hour slot. You get to pick the hour that you want to go in. And, yep, that's right, Marathon Man. I take a lot of Ginsu beans. I'm just saying. So we'll be doing that. That'll be in January. Also, we are climbing up on episode 100. Yay. This is episode 98 right here.
Oh, so God.
Yeah.
Oh, I have to get a dress. Wait, you didn't tell me. I need to get dressed. I need to find an outfit.
Oh, no, I'm not doing that. We get enough. You guys get enough fanfare from me. Oh, my God. I can't dress up in this hot office.
Oh, God. No. Don't do that. Don't do that, dude.
I'm like, it was hell when I did Wakanda Forever and I was in the hoodie. And I'm just like, Jesus, I got the window open. I just get hot, you know.
Yeah.
You want me to throw a suit on top of that? I don't know. You only see me from the waist up.
You get the t-shirt, the tuxedo t-shirt.
Yeah, you're going to get the logo with the shirt. And yeah, you get the fanfare and the celebration and boom, boom, boom. And, you know, who knows what's popping on. I don't know. I think of these things as they come. But yeah, we're coming up on episode 100. That's going to be a blast. When is it not ever a blast? We always have fun doing the show. We always have fun, whether it's guests or not. So it'll be game show as usual. Well, maybe not. Or games as usual. Or maybe not. Who knows?
Do the games, man. Do the games.
I'll probably do a game. I'll probably do. Maybe no giveaways. I ain't got nothing to give away yet.
Well, no.
like, y'all be playing to be playing. Just have fun. What we get? A corn on a cob. That's what we get. Where? Walmart. Wherever you live. I don't know. Here's a bus pass. Where you staying? DC? Okay, here. Here's $5. Venmo me you $5. So until next Tuesday at 8:30, where we'll be talking about all types of geek topic and entertainment news. As I always do with every show, remember to educate yourself and others, entertain yourself and others, and most of all, encourage yourself and others. Until next time when I see you guys, you'll be seeing me online. Make sure you give a follow, subscribe, hit that notification bell on the YouTube channel. And until then, we are out of here.